Alright, I know this is gonna sound very stupid, but hear me out. On output, on input device, click it, and then choose your input device, not default. Choose your microphone, and then quit Discord and reload Discord. It's sometimes just dumb that way. I know it is with my USB headset.
Hey, Flux.
Flux sounds Hello. Cranky.
I am rather cranky at having to have now three freaking chat services installed on my computer, but whatever.
I needed that shower. That was nice.
Oh, you're back.
Von Rosner said how to close Discord. It just
right click on the icon in the thingy. The little controller eyeball thingy that when you hover over it says Discord.
Okay,
right click that and quit setting that.
I don't want to have to keep hitting control like every like 5 seconds to talk.
Yeah, voice activity is the way to go.
I just gotta get it calibrated as we play.
Yep.
Fuck you, push to talk.
Eh. Oh, believe me, you anyway. Guys needed me with Push to Talk. Remember those times I passed
anyway,
out in the stream?
So how am I getting back in here now?
You should have an invite waiting for you. I sent it.
Nope.
Is that the email to your Roll20 account? Because if it's a different email, it's not going to work.
You never said you were sending me an email. I thought you had to have my email to give me.
I need your email to send an invite. And the email is checked against Roll20 accounts, and if it doesn't match a Roll20 account, it doesn't do anything. If it's the email matching a Roll20 account, then it sends a notice to that Roll20 account.
That's my email for the Roll20 account, so...
Then you have to check your account.
Already did. There's nothing there.
Anything
well,
in the email?
Well, then I don't know what to tell you, because I sent the invite.
All right, let's see. I need to... do a thing. What do I need to do? Oh, yes. My character's not Todd anymore. My character's name is... Ton Ray. And I need to... I guess I'll change
yes,
the...
I am not talking this time.
Really? It's still not working?
Try changing the push to talk button. Maybe the alt key is just not working.
Yeah.
Or we could just do this on Mumble. I think we've been doing.
I mean, I'm willing to do either.
Oh, that's a really annoying push to talk sound.
It is a really annoying push to talk sound. That's why I got rid of it. Also, I did a thing, and I don't know why I did a thing, so I'm going to get rid of the thing.
Von Rosner said no.
There we go. All right, is everyone here?
I am. If Zan can't figure this out in, like, the next 5 minutes, I am thinking about going to the Mumble, just in case. Does that sound good for everyone?
I mean, I'm not broadcasting over there, so good luck with that.
I'm streaming!
Von Rosner said, no, it's fine.
Okay. I'm still not broadcasting on Mumble, so good luck with that.
What do you mean, not broadcasting on Mumble?
As in, I'm muted on Mumble.
Why?
Because we're all here.
But Zon can't talk over here.
Zon's gonna have to figure that problem out, because if Mumble goes away, he's gonna have to use this.
Yeah.
Flux, is it just me or are you a little bit quiet?
I'm always a little bit quiet.
Yeah. Yeah. Have you met Flux?
Yeah, so Flux is always a little bit loud and Flux is always a little bit quiet.
It's my volume problem.
Formula Fox says and Razor. To close Discord, you have to right click on the tray icon.
Okay, let's see. Did I even spell that right?
Yeah, since you're asking, probably a no.
Probably not. Let's see. Just copy and fucking paste. There. I'm still the Fox icon because I haven't changed my icon yet.
Do you have the actual Discord app?
Formula Fox, and I'm sure there's another way to do it. But that's the way I go, and the only one I know of. Zondrazer said yes.
I don't know.
Well, at the very least, I do have text-to-speech on, so he should at least still appear in the stream.
I know that every time I plug in my USB headset, I always have to physically...
Be that as it may, Jerry, I'm also not going to deal with Zon having to be a silent character and type all the time. I did that with Shao. I kept up with it out of politeness, but never the fuck again. So, we need to fix this mic issue, or we're going to have issues with Zon being in the group.
Can you switch to voice activity for a sec? To see whether or not it'll work on voice activity at all. Because I know I have problems with things once in a while with this when I plug in my stuff.
Zon Rosner said changed.
All right, try talking now.
Zonraiser said anything.
No.
No.
Zonraiser, do you have Mumble up?
Oh, shit. He does. That's right. Close Mumble! Oh,
also,
my God.
Can I get another? Can I get another invite? It's not showing up.
Give me a second.
Totally forgot about that. Thank you, Neotag. That was Sovek's problem for the longest time.
Actually, that wasn't the exact problem, but yeah, that was my
a big
that
factor.
Would have been my early fix. No, it wasn't a big factor. It was because of the way my default mic settings are. Is that by default,
mumble and close
it uses
Discord before trying to talk again.
A specific setting that says only one app can use my mic at a time.
Yeah.
Damn it, that is not what I wanted to do. Fuck.
I disabled that on my end long time ago.
It finally came in.
Yeah, but my headset. Oh, good. I hadn't even sent the new one yet, so yeah, you just have to wait. You have to be patient.
Yay! We hear Zon making noise.
Oh, clock, 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 clock.
So, really, Mama?
Hello.
Lalalulelo.
Literally, the problem was Mumble was still open.
Lalalulelo.
Because Mumble was taking priority control.
Well,
problem solved.
Well,
you're welcome.
Well, Sir Thomas finished his vow of silence.
We're all here. We can do things now.
Yeah.
Let's switch to the things map.
Sovic, are you
everybody,
okay?
Everybody did things map. Why wouldn't I be?
You seem really short-tempered today.
No.
No, this is as usual.
Yeah.
I mean, the only reason I kicked you earlier was because I literally had an hour to prep something, and I was desperately wanting to try something
on the
GM side with some fucking macros.
Not that. Never mind. Fuck it. Forget about it.
Oh, it's on not being able to talk? No, that's just actually a serious button of mine that I held my tongue for the entirety that we played with Cheo. And that was very quickly being brought up by people being like, no, it's fine. We'll play with Zon not being able to talk. And I'm like, no, we won't. That is a serious no-no in my book. Button, pushed, hit. You have hit the Goku button.
No offense to Maze's group and all, but it's one of the reasons why I haven't gotten back to his group of players because they all do text only.
It drags the, unless everyone's doing it, in which case it kind of sets the pace itself because there's sort of an unspoken order to things when it comes to everyone typing. But if everyone's, but like a few people are typing, then it just becomes chaos and it's bullshit and it drags everything down.
Cool. I can't stand doing the typing thing.
Zon can play without talking. I'll just kill his character. And get his strength.
He can talk now, Flux. You don't need to kill his character.
Too late.
All right. So, punching of bears has happened.
Yes.
And beavers. And beavers. Let's not forget the beavers. That is an important part of it.
And wolves. We can punch many.
And wolves. I have the log still. I can look back and see all the things you killed.
And the occasional fox that possibly wandered in.
You know, one time I think we saw a bird and you threw me up into the air.
Yeah. And where?
Meanwhile, I've been in town fucking what's making important? Armor for somebody who's not in town right now.
There was a bird. I chucked Zon into the air. He punched the bird out of the air. It was all good. We showed that we
could. There's a bird. Kick its ass. All right. This could be an issue. I don't have that little booklet I usually use to keep track of what day it is.
Oops.
It's a bear punching day every day.
Am I a little loud?
The new it's new ship you're all right. is here. It's new ship is here and may have already left day. That's what
yeah,
it is.
But that doesn't tell me the exact day of the month or what month it is.
No,
for that matter.
I'm just being an asshole.
Well, stop. It's not. It's not helpful.
It should be on my desk, but it's not, and this disturbs me on many levels. My desk isn't that cluttered. I mean, there's like literally like three books on it and a couple papers and a coupon for pizza that I used and should have given to the delivery guy, but I didn't.
Yeah, they don't really give a shit most of the time about the coupons.
I mean, it's a free pizza coupon, but
yeah.
I already used the code online. So it's not like I can use the fucking code again.
Yeah.
It's a code so it's been verified.
Coupon. Yeah, when it's a code
anyway.
Coupon, you're like, fuck you.
Time the DM is unaware of because he has no recollection of exactly how much it was has gone by.
A month and a half.
No, it's not been a whole month and a half.
It was enough. It was a month so I could get enough ore and for the ship to come and be on its way out, is what you told me.
Oh, yeah. Well, no, it's not on its way out yet.
3 years has passed.
3 years has passed. The fox has died.
The fox
that's
is
how we
the fox.
That's how we solved that one.
Yeah.
I'll back on the ship.
Actually, not gonna lie, I probably will do like a 1 or 2 year time skip at some point when we hit a point where there's like really no point continuing on nitpicky like this. And I was like, okay, time to jump, the town's built up. What? But until then.
I'll have a massive store of ore to be used.
I mean, I'll tell you ahead of time when I'm doing the skip so you can sort out what you do with that ore so it's not spilt up because you're going to have to actively be using it.
Yeah.
I'm basically going to give you guys like a heads up, like 3 year and possibly like a level up or two. Figure Yay! Out what you did in that time. But not yet. All right, let's see. I got my calendar up now. Let's see if I can't guess what fucking day it was. All right, we went past New Sun. We went past Bright Noon. High Sun.
All I remember you saying is that...
Oh, right. It's fall. That's right. Yeah. I remember that.
You said it was fall. The new ship came in. The ore came in. And the ship would have already finished unpacking and would have been loading up the people to go back, is what you said.
Yeah, actually, that's interesting. According to my map, during the first month of fall, there are 2 eclipses of the positive plane. That's actually oddly...
Ending.
That is oddly
well,
that's oddly appropriate for fall.
So
actually, speaking of end times, it is the first day of Chillwind.
And you the first and whoever fall. Cared about having a goodbye party for Todd did as he got on the boat.
No one cared.
The boat hasn't shown up yet. The boat is about to show up in a minute. Don't get ahead of yourselves.
I
want to make a big deal out of the boat showing up, okay?
What's chill tide in?
Let me make a deal of the boat.
I don't want there to be a big deal of the boat. I want it to be common shit.
What's chill tide in not fantasy bullshit terms? Like, are we in
Chillwind? It's essentially October.
Okay. Formula Fox so said fudge.
No,
Fox.
Maybe
my birthday! So yay!
I gotta double check. That's November, October, September. All right, so it's September.
Oh, no Hallows Eve yet?
It's the 1st of September.
So what you're saying is we better get in that water and help the fish people quick, or we're all going
to
freeze.
Because the Atlantic's about to get fucking cold? No.
Yeah, or we're all going to freeze to death is what you're telling me. All
right, so it is the 1st of Chillwind.
I have a house. You have a house with a forge. You'll be fine.
I honestly wanted to ask this before we officially had the ship come in. Do we want to dial back about a week, go ahead and take care of the fish people with the big bad guards with us, or are we just going to take the mobs with us?
My follow-up question to that, do you want to do that with Flux and Zahn missing, or do you want to do that with them there?
Oh, right. Yeah, I mean, to be fair, Flux and Zahn are nice and all, but having those stormtroopers storm guard you mentioned?
Yeah, they left.
Awesome. Sound nice.
Yeah, no, they were never intended to actually be part of that fight.
Thank you.
Even if they were around and active, I was going to actually finagle it in such a way that you couldn't have used them anyway.
God
Unless
damn
they
it,
directly attack
15,
the city.
I wanted to have 15 to 20 of me just standing there throwing spells and shit.
Actually, the Storm Guard wouldn't be you. They'd all be werewolves and werebears and were-raptors and shit. No, actually, to be honestly, they didn't even send. They only sent like a couple war mages. Almost everyone they sent were auxiliaries.
So like half dozen or so.
Ignatius is notoriously cheap when it comes to helping other people. So they literally just sent a bunch of poor people with javelins and a couple like very low level war mages.
Oh, so they're all looking at me and like, okay, how the fuck do you use that spell?
They're looking at you like, hello, sir. It's sir, right? Oh, you're not in the military.
I
don't know.
I'm retired, fucker.
Yeah, they're all looking at you like, oh, you're like an officer, and they're all like first day fucking recruits.
I've done my term, motherfucker.
Anyway, so yeah, Flux and Zahn get back. Elves are with them. And as they're coming back, there's a big commotion at the docks as sails are spotted on the horizon. About 20 or so red sails, actually. There's about 20 boats showing up. Turns out, a colony successfully starting to build a new world with no real threat garnered a hell of a lot more attention than people thought it would.
I'm sure the jewel, gold, and all those precious metals had nothing to do with it.
They don't know about those yet.
All right.
How would they know about those? Have you been talking to the Archmage?
Carrier pigeons sent across the ocean. They actually.
Funny enough, one of them is glowing and floating slightly. Just to let you know.
There's what?
One of the boats is glowing and floating slightly above the water.
Which one would I be on?
Fuck, the mages are here. Get ready. It's crazy.
I'm heading down to the docks.
I'm going to be on the flying one just because.
Okay, well, the flying one is actually the last boat to show up because for some reason it's lagging behind, dragging something in the water.
I'm going to try and spot to see what the fuck they're dragging.
Okay, try it. Spot check, motherfucker.
No.
What you can tell is that it's very bright and you can't see shit.
Fuck.
Anyway, that boat shows up like an hour later, by which point all the other boats are offloading people. These don't look like the laborers that came with the first group. These look like people with actual fucking money. Your best guess would be that this is when all the middle class people are showing up. It looks like a lot of merchants, capitalists, people looking for adventure.
Well, there goes the neighborhood.
There's some people who come out with seemingly no possessions besides backpacks and weapons. Shittier weapons than all of yours, you note, but
customers.
The low levels showed up.
Customers.
Excellent.
You also estimate there's probably close to 1,000 to 2,000 people coming off these boats.
Oh wow! So we shot up.
Yeah. In fact, you can overhear the governor off to the distance while the elves are trying to get his attention. He's ignoring him. These being the elves that originally came with you, by the way. Going, shit, we didn't build enough houses. Crap. And trying to organize, like, quick build groups out of people while trying to keep enough people there to keep the ships going.
So did he come to us since we were so helpful in building the town at the beginning?
No, in fact, he doesn't even know you're there yet. And the elves are still pestering him, trying to get his attention, seemingly being very, very urgent about it. And Flux and Zahn are just kind of tacking around, throwing together, like, oh my god, you remember that bear? Bear, bro, bear.
I'm gonna
how many healths do they have?
I'm gonna walk up to the governor. What the fuck is going on?
It looks like the new arrivals have arrived.
Yeah, I noticed. I thought there was supposed to be maybe 1,000 at most. What the fuck? That looks like 3,000.
That's more than we were expecting. We were expecting another, like, 4 or 5 ships. We weren't expecting nearly this much. This was not in the projections. He sounds, like, partially panicked but happy at the same time.
I'm going to lean in and whisper, they don't know about the mines yet, do they?
Of course not. How would they? He sees the glowing ship coming. He's like, oh, thank God. Finally, they're here.
Oh.
That's okay. Going to help things a lot. And you know as he says that, you just hear a yahoo from the sky. As a man in shorts and a strange shirt that appears to be made of silk covered in a floral pattern comes out of the sky riding upon a strange board of wood and lands behind next to the governor. You recognize it as the Archmage.
Hello, Archmage.
Back from Florida.
Hello, how was your trip? Sir.
Oh, it was lovely. I went to Disneyland.
Ymir. What's a Disneyland?
He claps his hand and he's back in his normal brown robes that he'd been wearing around the colony. Okay.
You know what? Don't ask. Just let it go.
Okay, hang on. He looks at a strange device on his wrist. Okay. Okay. That's where I am. Okay, good. It was a watch, by the way.
No shit.
God fact, damn it, he is not the fucking
for those
doctor.
Of you who want to know,
no, he's not the doctor, Rolex. He's the fucking genie.
No, he's literally sword. Yeah, he's Sword in the Stone Merlin.
Fucking hell.
Yep. The Archmage is literally Sword in the Stone Merlin.
Maze said he ages backwards.
God damn it.
Yeah.
With a Rolex, because why not? In my world, Merlin was pimping.
So, what happened with those assholes in the forest? Said, I'm gonna look at Flux and Bara. Oh, no,
the elves look at you very angry. Thomas. Having heard that, it's like those assholes are our distant kinsmen. I'll have you know.
So are they?
I would have said no. I wouldn't have said that.
So are they actually using the infernal magic like we thought they were, or what's going on with that?
No. The lead elf looks super offended. You would even suggest that, and almost grabs his sword before his.
Oh, I don't. Oh, his arm. Excuse me. We got attacked by magical goddamn beasts. All right. The first time they were confirmed, Erno. The second time they were magical. They didn't say a word. We asked nicely. What do you want me to think?
I want you to think the truth that they've been fighting these infernal monsters for thousands of years.
But by ask nicely, you mean threatening to burn down
their
town?
You're not
there
yet. Yeah. Shut the fuck up. And actually, no. We asked nicely first. The threat came
after. They just
after
chose to ignore you.
Yeah. The threat came after several attempts at diplomacy. So, Red, go fuck yourself.
Anyway,
so can they actually speak
you'll be good
our
to know
language,
that a long
or
ship
is it more? Can they actually speak our language, or is it more grunts and thrusts?
Of course, they can speak the common tongue if they so deign.
Huh.
Well, you'll have better luck than me. They basically looked at me as if I was some kind of abomination.
Yeah, they're kind of assholes. So let's go meet our new. Let's go meet our new friends.
Yeah, but before that, real quick, interjecting, DM's prerogative. Flux, you notice a bunch of people dressed in furs and pointy hats coming towards you holding a giant chest.
My money's here.
they place the chest in front of you and go, for you, your majesty.
Thank you.
And then they leave.
And then you hear in the background, son of a bitch! And you probably recognize the voice, Flux.
For those who recognize the common folk.
Well, if you so choose to recognize.
I'm more interested in the fact that this person from Doran was on the maid ship, and it's a bit interesting.
So,
Yeah, that part is kind of weird. I jumped the galleon sized longship that just pulled in.
So, what is Flux's character's name again?
Cromwell.
Oh, why is that little rat thing humping your leg? What's going on here?
What?
I'm making a joke, Jackass. You're standing right next to him and you just yelled, "What the fuck?" or something.
Off in the distance you hear, "Son of a bitch."
Feel like you tried to interrupt Red Fox's character introduction, and it's kind of a dick move, Neotech.
It is.
All right, fine.
Neotech, sit in your corner.
No, I'm not going to sit in my corner. I'm walking to the fucking gate.
The Archmage cast hold person on you. Sit in your corner.
Yeah. Fuck you.
There are introductions being had. This is important to the destiny of the universe. Or maybe it's not.
Somehow I don't think it is.
He casts silence on you.
I approach Cromwell, give a very terse bow, and remark. I didn't realize His Majesty was going to be here.
I was the first person sent here.
Cromwell's a king?
Not king, like 13th in line. Something.
He's a prince.
He's of royal blood.
I don't keep track of the bodies.
And I don't keep track of people. I'll know at some point or other, but not right now.
I'll know them by the heads on my wall.
What are you doing here?
Trying to get away from the royalty.
Hi.
Damn it.
Why are you trying to escape royalty?
Because I want to be my own brat. That's why.
You could do that by going anywhere. Don't pursue you, I assume.
So, what's your name?
Matthias. Matthias Tonbray. I came here to start a new life and to make a lot of money.
I was one of those two. Nice to meet you.
And you are?
I am Bara Madare. I'm from Kadesh.
Oh, so you're not his servant. All right. How many of your servants are here, Your Majesty?
I need no servants.
Up until now, I had no idea he was royalty.
Serve that asshole? Fuck no.
I like you.
I already dealt with this shit once. I got out. No, never again.
I think you're a llama right now, Neotech. I don't think you have any way to
talk. No, that's just me goofing.
No, we're goofing around. Fuck you, Flux.
But let it be known, he could turn you all into llamas any moment.
What's a llama?
Oh, do you want to see?
No.
Yeah, please, show us.
Okay, he turns Neotech into a llama.
I'm cute and fluffy!
I start hugging the llama.
You hug him as he turns back. Right?
Well,
Oh, shall we meet the people who are coming else from the ship?
May as well.
I wonder if they have any more inferno-powered orbs. Let's go find out.
There aren't any more elves. In fact, that's the thing you notice. Not a single elf is on any of these new ships.
Hmm. Oh, well. Probably nothing important.
The Archmage does go over to talk to the mages, though. And he's happily talking to them.
Do I recognize anybody from Ignatius or anything?
No, it looks like it's mostly just merchants and peasants that are coming over from there.
No, I mean, okay, fine, never mind.
Hang on, my wife's talking to me.
You didn't put out the trash, and you need to wash the dishes!
She wanted to know what flavor Kool-Aid I wanted. We're making Kool-Aid.
Tropical punch. Always tropical punch.
We had just tropical punch last time, shut up.
Just whatever you do, don't do the purple stuff because it tastes terrible.
Yeah, the purple stuff doesn't mix right. No, purple tastes good when you buy it as purple, but when you buy it as the mix and then make it, it tastes off.
Yeah, it does.
Y'all just don't do it right.
Well, actually, no, it doesn't if you buy the single pack ones that go in like bottles of water. But the big, like, you mix it in a pitcher ones don't ever come out right for purple.
Yeah.
Come out right for me.
Yeah, fuck you then. Anyway, yeah. Unless you know any specific peasants that you want me to have showed up, not really.
No, I was talking among the mages as if.
You don't recognize a single mage. Hang on.
About Steve the peasant. I know him. Where's he?
So.
I sent Steve a buy one, get one free house coupon.
House
coupon.
So, Archmage, sir. If you can do us a favor, we weren't expecting this many people. I don't know exactly how powerful you are, but I'm assuming you are the most powerful being here right now.
He thinks for a moment. In the town.
We need about 1,000 houses built in that open land over there. Do you think you can do it?
Not become reliant on magic, but apparently your people don't know that.
He thinks a moment. It's like, oh, that'd be a gross misuse of my powers.
And
I liked your shirt.
Oh, thank you. I suppose if you gave me something.
All right. How much? All right, I'm gonna go over the party. How much do we want these houses built, and not having to worry about helping out with that? Everyone but Cromwell, who fucking didn't help build in the first place.
Listen, I'm of noble blood. I can build so much, but after that, I really care not at this point.
All right, I'm going to pull out the jeweled crown. Will this do?
He's laying down between everyone's legs, looking up at it. Oh, no, I don't really want that.
I have a family blade if you'd be willing to take that.
He then poofs away and reappears standing next to all of you. No, I actually had a specific thing in mind.
Oh god, what do you want?
Well, first I need you to sort out the things that you're doing here. It's very important. But when you have nothing else to do, if you wouldn't mind, just go south.
South.
Okay.
South fine with me.
Just go south, and he thinks for a moment, how best to say this?
I was planning on going north. Screw you, man.
I mean, you could go north too, but I don't think you want to just yet.
I want to more now.
Well, then you can. It's not like you've joined us on any of the adventures so far. Where were you when we fought the dragon?
He was doing important drinking things.
Yes, you were partying with fucking the Minotaurs.
And diplomatizing with them.
Where were you when I fought the Beholder? Oh, yes.
Anyway, I need you to go south and talk to the feathered serpent people with the rainbows.
Fucking with fish, if I
remember. I am... All right. I need to know this. Since this is what my character's been going for, would I be
This is the DM throwing you a bone. If you want magic, he will throw a plot hook at you.
Yeah, no, I'm good. But
there will be catches, and they will not be discussed at this moment.
Since I've been looking for this group, for my character...
There's enough to pique your interest character-wise, yes.
You don't mean... you don't mean the Rainbow Servants, do you? I've only heard rumor and legend. Dead,
but yeah, the things they served.
Interesting. I've heard rumors about them.
I haven't popped in for a few thousand years.
Wait, what? Guys, it was a few hundred years.
What year is it again? It says watch. No, it's only been a few hundred years.
We definitely should head south after we take care of the fish people.
Is there money involved?
It's very important. It's very important. When you talk to the snake people, tell them, and then he sneezes.
Gotcha.
Okay. I think I can remember that.
Is there any money in it?
Probably tons. I mean, I don't know whether or not you're allowed to have it, but there's lots of money.
Oh, there'll be shit tons of treasure there. It's just going to be a matter of if we can actually get our hands on it.
But no, seriously, tell the snake people Jilliam sent you, and... they might not bite you. I don't really know. It depends on how well they remember me. Or how they remember me.
Jillian? Your name's Jillian?
Is that a girl's name? Can you spell Jillian? That, please? I'm actually writing it down.
I will spell his name.
Sounds like a girl's name.
Jalim. That sounds very Middle Eastern.
Well, yeah, he is from Kaddish.
Sounds terroristy.
I mean, it could be. This is Merlin. So,
I wrote it down. All right. Well, so,
hang on. Big important things about to happen. As you take note of what he said, you notice it's getting dark.
Like, well, I'm naturally faster.
Think it's weird because last time you checked, it was about noon.
All right, I'm gonna look up at the sun first thing.
Only half of it's there and getting smaller.
Well, everybody, get ready for panic, because not many people understand what's about to fucking happen.
Oh God, the end times.
That's when the elves perk up, look at the lot of you, and say, "We need to go now."
All right, let's head out. All right, where do we go? Let's go.
They lead you into the forest and toward the elf territory.
Are you gonna shoot me now?
Please don't.
Because this was in my other notebook. Does anyone remember how long it took to get to the elves last time?
I took about 10 days.
A week and a half.
10 days.
Yeah, it took a week and a half to get there. We agreed to go a weekend. We didn't see anything. Then you said there were some signs of something, and I said, "Let's go for another 3-4 days." You said on the third day you noticed the owl bears.
Yeah.
Wanted to start looting. Can we go back?
No, you don't have to leave like immediately, but
oh sweet. Okay.
Alright, no, well I gotta do
Are expected to be booking it by the end of the day.
Alright, yeah,
I'm immediately heading to the store and getting 30 days of ration.
Zahn, I need you to come with me right away to my shop. Let's go. Thomas, I need you to come. I got your order ready. Let's go.
Alright. Come with.
Alright. Thomas, here's the deal. I made it as you asked. If you notice the symbol on the front to your liking, that's your family crest, if I'm not mistaken, at least what you drew on the piece of paper.
Mm-hmm.
I need you to take off your current armor.
Alrighty, Ben. I do so.
All right. And I'm going to start putting the armor on. I put these straps here, and I'm going to start teaching them how to put it on. I specially made this. You can now put on your own armor.
Perfect.
You don't need someone in case you're out in the field to help you with this anymore.
All right, then. Thank you.
All right. And you need walk around for a bit, get used to the joints, tell me if you need anything modified.
All right, I'll give them a try. I'm going to take my old set of armor. I'm going to put them inside my house.
As he walks to his house, there's panic in the streets.
Yeah, don't worry about that.
I talked to the mayor to see if there's lodgings for myself.
I mean, he offers you a place in the giant ass overcrowded flop house that's now got way too many people in it.
All right.
I politely decline that.
Are we still around the rat guy? Or is it just me and Zahn are off now?
I mean, unless anyone followed you, it's just you two.
Well, I first went to the convenience store to get 30 days of rations, and then headed to the shop.
Funny enough, you got there, and he doesn't have it anymore.
Yeah.
He's also closed up shop.
Yeah. Dude, we're not getting anything. This is emergency shit now.
Oh, shit. Well, thankfully I got a lot of arrows, so I can hunt.
Alright, Zahn, is the armor good? I'm gonna go meet up with the rest of the group. I recommend you do as well if you don't need any adjustments.
No, it's all good. I go fetch my horse.
By the way, Zahn, this was us role-playing here. I hope you understand.
Yeah, I know.
Alright, I'm gonna meet up with the rat who is badgering the person at the flop house at this point. No, is he still at the governor?
I don't know, Red. What have you done at this point? You've declined the flop house.
I kind of wander the streets.
Right. Just casually strolling amid the panic.
Yes. Can I meet up with you, Red? I'm going to give you an offer.
All right.
Hey, I remember you. You're the guy that said you liked me. That was a little weird. What's going on, man? Why are you running around?
I'm not running around. I'm casually strolling amongst the chaos.
Fair enough. What you doing?
Don't know.
Enjoying the chaos.
Yeah. Pretty much. It's kind of what I'm
watching the world burn. I don't know.
I'm giving you a trigger to tell me that you don't have a place to stay. My house is big enough to have an extra guest.
Don't say yes.
Fucking.
I'm not taking your conversation bait. I'm really not.
All right, fine then. Sure. Well, then. I say you meet up with if you're coming with us, meet up at the front gate. We lost this talking fox. I don't know what his deal was, but we could use another person talking. In this group.
His deal all right. Talking.
I got nothing better to do.
His deal was talking and not doing much else.
That was the one thing that fox did.
It's the only thing. No, that's literally the only thing he was known for in this group.
I can imagine that it was the moment the eclipse started is exactly when Todd is just like, fuck this shit, I'm out and just got on the near boat.
I'm just gonna
go on the glowy magic ship now and hope it leaves first.
I'm gonna go talk to Bara, tell him to meet us at the front gate, and then head there and wait for everybody to show up.
I get to the gate.
I go see Todd off on his ship and I wish him the best of luck.
I mean, I don't think any of the ships are leaving just waiting to leave.
We are leaving.
At this point, people are panicking, running around. Ship captains are refusing to let anything happen.
Like, we might be gone, and he might be gone as well.
That's going to happen. The DM is nipping the tearful farewell in the bud because shit needs to get done.
Tearful farewell. I'm good. It's going to take everything I have not to put a magic missile up his ass.
Which I'm also nipping in the bud.
I think it's time to head back to the mainland.
This seems like a good time to just say, "Well, this failed."
All right, we're at the main gate.
Yeah, okay, you notice the elves are all standing in a circle and chanting and drawing lines with chalk in the grass.
Ooh, a magic circle! I wonder what they're doing.
I end elfin magic shit.
I'm going to walk up to the nearest one that's not chanting and say, so we're here, we're ready.
Good. So are we. At that moment, the magic lines in the ground start glowing and a big-ass portal opens up in the middle of the circle.
Okay, that's cool.
Neato.
Says,
is it red?
No, but you can see what's on the other side of it.
Is it fire?
It's ruins. Those elves that you don't like, lots of screaming and shooting of arrows and glarble sounds.
Looks like they need some help. All right, I'm running in.
Time to be big damn heroes.
They were assholes, but they're dying. They need help. Let's go.
They can't be picky when it comes to allies.
They're still assholes. Let's go.
You also noticed as you ran through that unlike here, where the sky is really dark, over there the sky was bright, but not the usual bright color.
Oh, great. Do I notice any of... Oh, God.
Red.
How do I say this? Would I be able to feel any difference within the magics I use?
Not unless you were there.
Oh, I've already crossed the portal, so...
Okay, yeah, you said that.
Has everyone else crossed the portal at this point?
Yeah.
I'm the last one to jump in, but yeah.
I'm not just randomly crossing the portal. Fuck that.
I mean, the elves are going through too, to be fair.
But
Chromo, do you want a bunch of elves to upstart you?
I'm gonna yell through the portal. I knew Cromwell was a chicken!
Soon I'm going to take that bait. He's also giving me no explanation.
Old Cromwell would have taken that bait.
New Cromwell is wiser.
New Cromwell only cares for bears.
Learned from the bears.
He's learned humility and being one with nature. It's pretty obvious what's going on when you get to the other side, considering the part where it's raining fire.
Ooh.
What?
Ooh.
I better get my
cold raining
spells.
Fire.
I better get my cold spells ready.
The sky is blood red, it's raining fire, And as you can tell, the glow in the sky is coming from a nearby ruined building that all the elves are desperately trying to fight their way to.
Alright!
What's coming out of the building, what's streaming out of the building, is weird little gloop, is man-sized gloop creatures with horribly tortured faces screaming in garbled agony.
Ooh, demon fun! Alright, you guys ready?
Possessed ones.
I take note of this. And all of a sudden, you
see... Welcome to the party, rat man.
All of a sudden, you see Matthias go from a lanky little thing sprouting fur and becoming very much a bipedal rat.
Wow, you're already more useful than the talking fox. Let's go.
So,
okay.
I don't want any part of this or no.
I mean, I have no reason to help. I don't know who they are. I don't know where this place is. Mama taught me not
After
to
all that time you spent bonding with them over bear slaughter?
No, I bonded with elves who would maybe tell me before they jumped into a random portal. I've got no reason to just go gallivanting through portals with elves.
I mean, these elves came with you because they were hanging out with the other elves.
They still don't give me any reason or explain what's on the other side. I'm not just jumping into a portal with some randos.
But one of the elves looks at you and says, there's not much time. We need to get that portal closed before everything is doomed. Not even just this world, but all of it. All
right, seriously. If Flux isn't coming, he isn't coming. It's not the first time he's not joined.
This is basically the point where does Flux want to just sit out the session?
I need a reason to go into this fucking portal.
I mean, the elf just told you the end of the world.
Everyone else that you know has gone into the portal. If you're still not coming, just sit down.
The elves on the outside are just looking at you like, hello, end of the world, as one of the other elves goes off and is trying to get like people from the town to like come as well.
Okay. I'm rolling my initiative now. I'm done waiting on Flux to character.
Well, you can roll your initiatives, but you're not going to need them just quite yet for another minute.
Piling in. Switching into wolf. Well, actually, I'm always in hybrid form now.
Ah, Cromwell decided to join us at long last.
I'm sorry, I don't trust portals as much as you pansies do.
It's just magic. God,
is the prince afraid of a little portal?
I'm afraid of fucking elves from randomly child-porting me to places I don't know about.
I thought we were friends.
It almost sounded like you said child-porting you to random places.
Look, Cromwell, what it comes down to is, do you want to help these people or not? If the answer is no,
I don't know who these people are.
They're dying, screaming, and everyone's panicking. And this is
that's something that happens every now and then in this world. I can't help.
Yeah, and the Archmage told us to come here, and that's all I needed. Let's go.
They all did. The Archmage told us to go south.
No, the Archmage said something very
important.
After
you're done doing everything you need, everything that has to get done up here, then go south. Okay. Those were his exact words.
And he also said right before the eclipse happened, he said something very important is about to happen, then fucking...
Hey, you know what? You know what the important thing might have been? Some fucking elves tricking us into a death portal.
I mean, he is right, but he's wrong.
Well... He never met my mother.
Anyway, is anyone else going to roll their fucking initiative?
Oh, okay, we can do that now.
No, I thought you said we weren't doing that just yet.
Well, I want you to roll it now anyway, just so I can put it up on the fucking turn order, since I have to do it manually for almost all of you.
Well, here's the problem. Is that going to stay when you change the map?
It should.
Crap. I actually got a higher initiative than I usually get.
27.
Fuck you, higher than me. By one, you motherfucker.
Actually, no, all
right, Kiri.
13 because of Raptor form. Because fuck that, not staying. Fuck that, no.
You're using the wrong slash.
Yeah, Kiri, slash the other way.
Isn't this the third time we've had to tell you that?
Retreats backwards.
Hold on, I did it wrong. It should be one less. Shouldn't it?
All right, well, what's your dex?
Oh, no. Why is it one less?
Whatever, I'm keeping it 27.
Whatever.
Okay.
He doesn't want to deal with two people having the same initiative.
I mean, I could, but I don't want to. Okay, and these things have a plus 0. Okay.
Oh, wait, no, it's completely wrong. I forgot I didn't have that. My bad.
You don't have improved initiative, do you?
No.
All right, so it's a 20... 23.
Anyway, so...
No, actually, it's just one less. It's literally 26.
Whatever.
But, yeah, just leave it at 27.
We'll fix it next time. Yeah. All right, so when everyone's on the other side, the elves are slowly finding their way to the building as one of the wild elves looks at you and says, "Ah, it's you. Very well. If you want to prove yourselves as friends of the elves and save this damn world-forsaken world, get to that building right now."
Did you just say world-forsaken world?
Shut up. The DM had got tongue-tied.
Well, clearly you can't handle it, so yeah, we'll fucking bail you out.
We could, but it would cost many elven lives. Or we could send you, and you could fix it. Or it will be casualties thinning out their numbers that we don't care about.
Not making me happy about my heritage. All right,
that portal's still open?
No. In fact, it was never open on this side.
Okay.
It was a one-way portal.
Would you look at that? Looks like we're fucked. I guess. Wonder who called that.
You know what? I think I'm just gonna sit back and let the elves die unless they fucking actually ask for fucking help.
That was about as tough as you guys get from them. Although the high elves that came with the ship say, forgive their rather gruff ways. They're very uncivilized. We will, of course, offer you great compensation if you'll aid them in this. It is
I'll
take his compensation if he doesn't need it.
I don't need the compensation to help.
You'll also
him,
die.
I will
don't
take
help.
It anyways. Let's go. No, I'm trying to. I was trying to basically say, all I wanted was an ask for help, but I'll take the compensation as well. Let's do this.
I mean, that was more for the people who didn't care about the world ending and possibly dying horrible, horrible deaths if this isn't stopped right now.
If the world ends, I at least take my mother with me.
Okay, well, the funnel of bodies that are friendly kind of funnel you all into the building, which you will now all charge into. Welcome
like
to the map, you're on.
A body railroad.
It's almost like a hallway of people
wow, this is
telling you where to go.
Huh.
It's checkers. It's a game of checkers.
Only some of them are cheating and are next to each other.
I'm guessing that red thing at the top's the building.
No, that's the portal.
That red thing at the top is a giant glowy portal filled with flames.
That's what we have to destroy.
And reeking of brimstone and sulfur.
It's like one of the commandments.
That's what we have to destroy. So, where exactly are we on this map?
Yeah,
you guys are at the bottom. And because of the way the thing works, I can't draw the bottom part without it just creating a straight line between those two points. So actually, hang on, let me just freehand it. I will freehand where the door is. Doors are here. So that's where you're coming in.
Okay.
All right. Doable.
Still don't have the tokens up yet.
I know.
I
gotta find your tokens, because I had to make a token in my token list for each of these tokens. I have to find where I put characters.
Can you resize tokens?
I mean, I can.
Because I will be on my horse for this combat, and I will need to be a large.
All right, let's see. I need this to be 41 of
40. You're lucky you're just big enough to fit through that fucking doorway.
Yep.
All right, I don't have permission yet. All right.
Do you not?
No, you kicked me. Everything got reset.
Oh, right. Hang on. That's not who I want. I want Ymir. Edit. Ryan, save. All right, now you should have it. If not, I'll just delete and redump the token.
I can move it now.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to recommend we let our newly armored friend run through the middle and try to open us a hole.
The fact that he's now a large creature, when the fuck did that happen?
Well, because I'm on a horse.
He's on the horse.
And And so I share the same space as the horse.
I still represent the fact that he's in the same space as his horse.
When did your horse come up through the portal? How did you get a horse to go through a portal?
Did you not hear me saying I bring my horse?
I did say it was a big portal.
Why'd you damn your horse to this hell?
Because if he's going to die, he shall die upon his mighty steed.
I thought it was a horse. Now you're saying it's a steed. God damn it.
Same thing.
I would use you as a steed.
Being way too specific with animal types.
No, it's literally the same thing.
I, being an I get enough being of that shit from Dr. Captain's Discord.
Alright.
Alright. Red's first.
Yeah, Red is actually first this time.
Oh, yeah.
I want to actually warm up on us instead of just where Sovic placed him.
Yeah, yeah. No, you can form up where you want. I'm going to need to get the thing out for this. Horses aren't... Okay. Alright, if I am correct, this is going to be fun for you.
If you're
and then
not,
eventually fun for me.
If you're not, you'll have to be work on the fly and downgrade all their levels.
No, I said this is going to be fun for you because I'm hoping I don't need to upgrade this encounter. I think this is set up in such a way that we're going to have a fun gradual climb.
I assume everyone's in the same idea that we're rushing for the portal to destroy it and then clean out the room.
Yeah.
What's all those circles?
Those are pillars holding up the crumbled ceiling. That doesn't exist anymore. Some of the pillars are like half fallen.
The ceiling's not there anymore?
The ceiling is not there anymore. And most of these pillars are either half or quarter pillars.
You're a dick.
And the rubble has long since been lost to time and ground to dust.
God damn it. I wanted to bring the ceiling down on this one.
Yeah, that'd be great, but he's not going to give us that easy an out, and you know.
Even the pillars themselves are not tall enough to really do any damage, even if he did manage to knock them down. All you would do is just create rubble areas that would create difficult terrain.
So, yeah. I think I'm going to... let's see. Do I have my weapon? We don't have our weapons sheathed or unsheathed, do we?
Yes, we do, dude. We charge.
I assumed you all came in here charging with your weapons unsheathed.
Yeah,
right,
dude.
Right.
Okay, then I'm going to activate my first charge of my
Rogue's Blade.
And 1, 2, 3. Go over here and attack that guy.
Okay.
He is considered flat-footed
because
of Blink. That's D20 plus 11.
Keep in mind, you get a plus 2 to hit because of the spell.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
He also would have been flat-footed because he didn't act yet.
Yeah.
So that's like plus
13. Yeah, I know.
Oh, Room is currently flat-footed.
Yeah, everyone who doesn't act already is flat-footed.
But the Blink spell lasts longer than one round.
Yeah, everyone's gonna be flat-footed for a while. I get that.
Except for me, I don't.
All right, well, you hit him.
Hold on.
You definitely fucking hit him.
That is my crit range, so I have to roll again.
Okay, roll the quit. Roll the quit. Okay, you hit him.
No crit.
Oh, that is crit.
Awesome. You confirmed it.
Awesome. I haven't done it. I haven't actually critted in ages.
Hey, it's right, amazing that's... when your character's actually useful and not a fucking talking fox.
It's amazing when the enemies are challenge rating 1.
Amazing when they're all fucking the MERS.
They're all mooks. They're literally
just little goblin things from
down. They're literally just the cannon fodder of devils.
I know,
let's see.
I know.
1d4
that's
plus
why there's 40 4.
Okay, so times 2 on that.
Hang on, you said plus 4? And it's a crit, it's dead.
No, I said times 2 on that, so it's 10.
It's still dead. Are you guaranteed to do at least 9 damage? It's dead.
Okay.
It's dead.
I'm gonna roll my sneak attack damage, but okay.
No, it is dead. It is dead the minute you said 4 times 2 plus your roll.
Yeah.
No, I said 4 is an F-O-R.
The attack on the other hand is going to be fun.
Not the number 4. Five
the attack.
Whatever.
It is your turn.
Yes, I am looking at which spell I'm going to use. I think I know.
Don't you have an AoE spell?
Oh, I've got a couple. I don't have that many, though. I wish I had more.
Oh, come on, Neotag. Let us see what you cast.
I don't have level 3 spells yet. Damn it. All right. Move there. I can only take out 2 at a time. Damn it.
I guess that's a good representation of the blink spell.
Yeah, good enough.
God, I'm trying to see something real quick. Oh, no, I got exactly what I want. Burning hands. What do I got to do this one?
It's a touch attack, isn't it? Oh, no.
No, it's just a... It has no roll. That's not right.
It's because it's a touch. It's a touch.
Yeah, it's a touch attack. That's why there's no roll.
No, it's not a touch attack. It's a 15-foot cone burst.
Yeah, it's just an automatic cone because it's a reflex save, I think.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah.
All right.
So if it's a cone, when
it should hit the 3 and the 4 in front of me, I think.
Okay. It hits them.
All right.
Kira, your turn.
They're all immune to fire.
What gave it away? The fact that they're devils? Or no, the fact that the portal is flaming?
I wanted to confirm, and quite frankly, right. It's the only thing I could do.
Move 10 feet.
Yeah, no, I designed this encounter with one thing in mind, and that's I want to do a mob fight where Neotag has to think.
No, it's I know what I'm doing. It's just I wanted to do that to show everyone.
21 to AC.
Okay, you hit. Which one are you hitting? Okay. Roll your damage.
Can I roll to purposely miss?
No.
22.
Okay, it's dead. I don't know why you hit, why your damage is a d20, but okay.
Wait. Wow, never mind. I don't know why I did that.
I know what your damage is. It's probably dead anyway. I assumed you moved to activate your skirmish.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's dead. I don't think it's possible for you to not kill it with your skirmish damage. All right, Zahn.
And so you say they're flat-footed?
Yeah.
Okay.
If that makes you feel better.
Well, okay. I move there. And I use one of my challenges, the big aura one.
That's a good question. Does that technically provoke attacks of opportunity from the two guys on the side?
Yes. Yes, it does.
Okay.
All right.
I hope you upped your AC count for the new armor.
No.
Yeah, no, they both miss. They just kind of flit and affect you with their goopy arms.
I have to bring this up.
A quick question, I'm sitting here waiting for my next turn. Do they have visible fire on them? Any of them?
No.
Darn. Then I can't do that. Never mind. I was going to turn one of them into a smoke cloud to block the other one's visions.
No, the fire literally hit them and then just sizzled out.
No, I mean, do any of them are visibly on fire?
No. They're literally like animate piles of ectoplasmic soul goop screaming in agony.
Okay.
So
I don't get any good area attacks till next level.
These things are literally gestalt tortured souls.
So if they can understand me, I don't know if they can. If they can't, then this is wasted. But they need to roll a will save of 15 or higher. Of everything at about 100 feet of me.
Okay. They don't seem to take any notice of you.
All right. Then I raise my shield.
They don't even seem to notice any of you are here until you're, like, in attack range. Right.
Okay.
They seem kind of stupid. Almost like they don't have brains.
Yeah. Then I raise my And I do my shield block against the one that's just in front of me, and that's my turn.
Okay. Flux?
That one?
Yes, that is the one that's in front of him.
Okay. I'm gonna rage, and I'm gonna do a charge. Take your op attack. It's not... You can just...
Not that it's gonna do anything?
Yeah, you can ignore doing anything for that. And then I'm gonna bull rush this goop guy. I'm just plowing through these fuckers. So, we're gonna make... He gets to make an op attack against me.
Yeah. Not that it does anything.
Nope. And now we make opposing strength checks.
Have fun now.
That's his strength check. All plus zero of it.
Oh!
We both go back here.
Alright, does that actually push the other guy out of the way?
I wonder what the AC of the portal is.
He was here, so he gets pushed there.
Okay.
I think that might be a good target for you.
Is that your turn?
I believe so. I don't think I can... Hold on, give me a second. Now, okay, it says... I can be bull rush as part of a charge, but it doesn't say if I don't get my attack at the end of the charge.
No, you still get your attack.
Okay. Do you want me to roll for this?
I think it's dead. Not gonna lie. Roll just to see if you hit. Okay, you hit. It is dead.
It's a 17.
It's just splattered goop all over the walls. Well, the pillars. The walls have long since rotted and fallen away.
I'm going to be doing 11 damage.
Okay. It's their turn. And in reaction to your slaughtering them, they all just start making a wailing noise in unison. And the portal fluctuates. Uh-oh. And something comes out.
Are you kidding me?
Hey, Chitons.
I don't like the looks of that thing.
Hello, Mr. Chain Gordon. How are you today? And now they get to take their turns. The one to the top left of Flux is going to try to hit Flux and flail ineffectually, as I am sure that is exactly what it's going to do.
Yeah, you're 20, it's not gonna do anything to me.
Yeah, no, he's gonna try and hit you.
Can't do shit.
And the ones around Zahn are gonna try and hit Zahn. Each have two attacks, by the way.
Is it the one in front of Red dead?
No.
No, he did one that was diagonal.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
There are two in front of me.
None of those.
This guy's gonna come over.
No.
I'm gonna look over at Edson. I'll race ya.
Am I allowed to charge through things?
Nope.
Doesn't get your horse get an attack?
Nope. Not even close. Yeah.
Unless you had like a trample attack, which I don't believe
you're. Unless you roll a nat 20, you're not gonna hit me.
That doesn't stop them trying.
My AC's 22 currently. You ain't doing shit to me. Plus, you have a 50%, you have to roll percentile, even if you do, because I'm currently in blink spell. So you have a 50% miss chance on
trying again to hit Flux.
Just tell me when it's my turn, and I'll be back, but I think I'm safe here.
Trying to hit Zahn again.
Oh, I wish I had my level 3 spells already.
Any of those hits on?
No. Oh, wait. The top one did. The 21.
Oh, my God. I should look up how much damage they do.
Are you sure?
My AC
is 21. You do have new armor, remember?
Yeah. No, it's changed. I have an AC of 21.
All right. It does... two damage.
Oh, goody.
Smacks you with its gloopiness.
Better bust out that healing belt right away.
All right. I think we get the picture that they're trying to basically body block you from the portal.
You sons of bitches.
Alright, I'm gonna ask out of character, would you guys rather want guaranteed kills or would you want severely weakened monsters?
But we already have guaranteed kills, dude.
AEOs.
And weakened monsters.
AEO.
Well, no, here's the thing. I wanna do Whirling Blade, which does the damage of my long sword, so it would only do 1d8.
Just look, here's what needs to be done. Just get me a line to here.
Oh, whoops, that's not what I meant to do.
Get me a line to this man.
Funny thing, also, hang on, I gotta add him to the initiative, actually.
Wish I had a weapon that pierced. I mean, a fucking spell that pierced.
Okay, funny thing hasn't happened yet.
Alright, I'm gonna attack the guy right here.
Which one? I wasn't looking.
This one.
I have, like, dead in front of you? Okay.
Yeah. 23.
Okay, he's hit.
Alright. And my sneak attack. And that. And that.
You're dead.
Alright, I'm gonna sidestep over here. And I will be right back.
Okay, new attack.
Okay, it's called Whirling Blade. Do you want one roll for everything in front of me, or do you want one roll for, or do you want me to roll 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times?
8 times.
Okay.
Wait, there's only 7 things in front of you.
No, I'm also hitting the portal.
Okay. All right, first thing's hit. Second one is not. Third one is. Fourth one is not. Fifth one is. Sixth one is. Seventh is not. It goes through the portal.
All right, now it returns, and the spell makes it return to my hand. Guaranteed.
Okay, it doesn't come back to the portal.
Returns without error is what the spell says. Nothing stops it from returning to my hand.
That's
literally the spell Whirling Blade.
Hang on a second.
This thing coming back as the same as it entered, or is it coming back as magnetic, like hot?
Okay, it comes back and the portal's bigger now.
Uh-oh.
You just ripped the portal a new one, and it has widened.
Let's see. So, how many hit? God damn it. One.
It was the first, two, third, four, fifth, sixth,
the
13's and seventh.
Missed, and the 16 missed.
One, two, three, four, five.
One, two, three, four. Four. Four hit. You missed the chain golem.
All right, in that order, that's how much damage they took.
Okay. He is
dead.
Hang on. I just need a line neotag and I'll run through here.
High yeah, it starts, the damage life. Starts at, wait, where did the damage start again?
Started
as the one, right?
At the five.
Yeah, the five, four, then two tens, and a six.
He was actually still alive then. He's alive.
That's my goal, Flux, is I'm
trying alive.
Trying to fucking make a line for you to rush towards it.
Dead. Wait, who else was... Oh, fuck it, he's dead too.
Alright.
You made a giant line that I couldn't keep track of. Thank you. Okay, so that your turn?
Yes, that's it for all
right.
You know what? I shift forward one.
Okay, Kiri.
I move four.
Him?
Yep. 18 days, right. See?
Yep.
Well, these things aren't crystalline structures. Nope, that's not gonna work.
They're like gentlemen.
Yeah.
Alright, 13.
Shatter would just make them jiggle.
And is that your turn?
Yeah, it'd be my turn.
Zahn?
Okay. Now... with my lance, do I reach the person behind the person in front of me? Or would it hit the person direct beside me?
Reached him.
You hit the guy 10 feet away, not the guy next to you.
Okay.
I think Cessna's his weapon could penetrate an enemy into another enemy.
No, penetration is not a thing without magic.
Yeah, unfortunately.
I'm also not sure Lances... Do Lances have reach?
Actually, I think that Lances do have reach.
Lances do have reaches. I just...
You can.
Yeah, okay. Strike. They have reach, so what that means is you can't hit anything next to you when you have reach.
Right.
Everything next to you cannot be hit by you. Only things 10 feet away from you.
Yeah, no, I'm just making sure.
Yeah.
Quick. 10 feet.
Do you have a shield zone?
Yeah, I have a shield.
Okay, because I was about to say, it's one hand, Lance. You could have just punched a person.
Well, on a horse.
I mean, is the guy doing 9 damage with a punch?
Well, I'm just saying, like, on a mount, I wield the lance with one hand.
Yeah.
Yeah, unfortunately, piercing is not a thing unless you have a spell like the one I just used.
Or, like, some edge case weapons.
There's a couple of feats that let you pierce with arrows, but other than that...
I'm going to be hitting...
No, I can pass through him. You don't... If you're only getting him out to move up, make a path, I don't need that.
You don't need me to make... Get him gone?
Yeah, because I can move diagonally.
Okay.
Then, split between these two demons, giving him pats on the butts as I run through.
Alright, then I hit the guy...
I like how you and Cromwell were on the same page right away. Make a path to the fucking demon in the portal.
I'm going to be hitting this one, then.
I have no need for the small men. I know who the big guy is. At least until someone fucking ripped a hole in the portal.
Yeah, not going to lie. I think I'm going to play with that a bit.
So, does that hit?
That does not hit.
Okay. Then I raise my shield against the one in front of me.
I mean, it's literally just a normal sword being thrown magically.
All right. Chain Golem's turn. He's going to move here.
Ah, it's time. You beautiful son of a bitch.
And...
Did that provoke an attack of opportunity?
Actually, no, he's not going to move there. He's going to move here. Do I want him to? Fuck, hang on.
The way you get him.
He has abilities, and I really want to use them, but it's a full round action, and I don't know if I want to make a move, because you may kill him before he gets to use it.
It Thomas he was under those chains.
He could always hold his turn and see how this goes, but that's probably not going to work out for him very well.
No, fuck it. He's coming. He's coming for you. Just stand there to attack you. Because he has reach if he wishes. One D 20 plus shum shum.
Yeah, no.
Okay, his two chains that fling out of his massive chains just flail at you but miss.
I'm a no sell those. I'm not even gonna look at him.
Okay. And as his turn ends, this comes out of the portal.
More chain devils.
Well, no, only one of these is a chain devil.
Did you fucking lie, those are both chain devils.
No, one's a chain golem, and the other's a chain devil. Yeah. They are very distinct creatures with different abilities.
Stupid nonsense creatures.
I mean, chain devils make chain golems, so I mean, you're kind of right, but...
You know, you'd think if the elves knew there was going to be portal here, they would give us a scroll of hold portal or something. Close portal. Anything.
You'd almost think like they tried that before.
Almost like I'm going to jump through that portal and cut down whatever on the other side.
Alright, it is Flux's turn.
Okay, so we're going to full attack. So, to Jim... Oh, hold on. For Jimbo Slice right here.
Jimbo Slice.
An 18. You want me to roll for his damage?
No.
Okay.
Jimbo Slice is dead.
And then we're gonna move. We're gonna take a 5-foot movement in the middle of my full attack. And hey, bruh. Two attacks go into the chain golem.
Okay. Roll them.
How do you attack, move, and attack?
You can move in the middle. You can do a 5-foot move in the middle of full attack.
Oh, okay.
Okay. They both hit.
Don't jump on him, Ymir yells.
So part of me that will laugh if you manage to just outright kill it, and then there's a part of me that'll be sad.
Nat 20.
I mean, he could nat 20, but it's also a construct, so it can't take critical hits.
That's 48 damage.
Okay, you tear the chains asunder.
Hey, bro, guess who's got 9 strength mod right now on a two-handed weapon?
Point to the chain devil. Coming for you next.
Alright, I need to grab something real fast.
Oh, and, claw attacks. So, let's go with Jimbo A and Jimbo B.
And, Jimbo A and Jimbo B are dead. Which Jimbos were Jimbo?
Jimbo A. That one's Jimbo B.
I think he missed one.
Did I miss?
He did miss one. Okay. And I only saw one of your pigs, so I'm assuming that was the one you killed.
Jimbo A is like, wow, good thing I'm not that guy. That's just a claw back in.
All right. And that is your turn?
Yes.
Okay. I need to do a thing real fast.
No, don't do a thing real fast.
Oh, I'm doing a thing real fast.
Damn it.
super wide portal.
Come on, let me type you fucking program.
No, you're not allowed to.
Okay, so
I actually just realized I did that wrong, but I
whatever.
Had two attacks. Whatever.
All right, he's going to move.
Hey, Jimbo.
And flail at you.
Hey, Jimbo. Oh, that one hit. Look at that.
Oh, he hit.
Look at that.
He does one damage.
Look at that. It doesn't even scratch me. You can't get through damage reduction.
Jimbo. All right, guy to the right of him. He hit because I rolled the wrong damage. I rolled the wrong roll. Yeah, that's what they should be doing.
In Jimbo's mind, he was a hero.
Jimbo's mind for a moment, he was channeling the spirit of his fallen master.
Yeah.
If only I had fucking cleave, this would be great.
Alright, now. This guy's going to attack Zahn, and he is flanking.
Okay. No.
Which?
Oh! Oh, shit.
Nope.
Yeah, I think that does, doesn't it?
Does it hit you?
Does a 21 hit your AC normally?
That's my AC.
21 is your AC. Oh, okay.
If this one fucking lemur takes you down, it immediately gets promoted.
He does 4 damage.
A massive 4 damage. No!
And oh, no.
Actually, he would have hit anyway, even if 21 was his AC, just because of the flanking bonus.
Yeah. Right,
guy opposite him is going to attempt to... Nope. And the guy below the one who actually hit you. Nope. And the guy below that. Nope. The guy in front of your mirror.
That's a no.
Gonna try and hit red.
No. Nope. Like I said, the only way you're hitting me is if you roll a nat 20. And you won't crit.
Coming for Cromwell again.
No, hold on.
Jimbo's coming.
Who's attacking Cromwell? Because they're now getting flanking bonuses. So like...
I know. I get
like, oh my god, he's almost surrounded, really.
Yeah.
Does flanking bonus a stack? I don't think they do.
No.
Maybe like all 8 of them, maybe all 7 of them could like attempt to grapple him at the same time. And they get torn to shreds.
Oh, don't worry. Okay, Cromwell's so about to have a whole
red,
open.
It's Red's turn.
All right. Well, I think I'm going to go here and here. Yes, I take the attacks of opportunity. Go ahead and roll them. I don't care.
How many attacks of opportunity?
Oh, let's see. This one, this one, this one, and this one.
Like, and the guy below him.
Oh, yeah.
Nah, he highlighted that one.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm gonna
really slowly at you.
Yeah, and I'm gonna take this guy on. So
okay. Hit and dead.
And yeah.
You don't get to roll damage, he's dead.
He dead.
You get sneak attack damage for the next 5 more rounds.
Is that your turn?
Yep.
Alright, new attack.
Centered there.
4 more rounds.
Wait, centered where? I didn't see. Okay.
On that corner, basically, the 3 that touched,
yep,
all take damage.
What kind of damage?
It's what's the spell called again? It's Hail of Stone. So just rains of stone fall on them and they die.
Oh, thank God, not fire.
It's just like not non-elemental damage.
Yeah, good.
Okay, they're dead.
Go, Cromwell, go!
Well, it's not his turn yet. All right, Kiri.
All right.
The intent of that is clear.
Oh, I don't know if I can actually do that. But I so wish I could just shoot that guy from there, but I can't.
When the lever boys fall, Cromwell's still pointing at the chain deck.
Oh, if I could get away with not hitting any of you guys, I'd do that.
You can. You could shoot into melee. You have all the feats. Just do it.
Alright, I'm gonna hit aim for the chain devil.
Which is not in melee, so you're fine.
You're basically lobbing it over our heads, dude.
Yeah.
Wow.
Nope.
That is... sails into the...
sails into the portal. God damn it, first a sword, now
it's bigger.
Okay. Actually, I probably should have been counting that. I forgot all about that.
What's next? A giant barbarian?
I forgot these lumers had damage reduction.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
I assumed you were counting them in.
No, I wasn't. But for the most part, they've all been dead, except for the ones that... Actually, yeah, no, they've pretty much all been dead, except for some of the ones that Ymir hit.
Can I roll an action point and try again?
I did not be wrong. Yeah, no. You do no such thing. And that is your turn. And Kiten gets to go here.
Yeah, bruh.
He's using the proper noun.
Yeah, this isn't a 4.0. There's no action points.
They were also an Ebron. All
right, hang on. What does this two things do?
I don't know. They're included on the 3.5 character sheet.
I don't think that's a good idea, because I'm pretty sure Flux can make a DC 15 will save.
Come here, bro. Come on. Come here. Come here. You know you want to.
But does the creature know he can't? You gotta keep that in mind, so let him try, bro.
Hang on, where did the chain devil die? Right there, right?
Yes, it did.
Huh. Okay. Hang on.
Yes. I will point out, where's my dump stat? Not my dump stat, but it's not my best stat.
There, chains. Yeah, alright, he is going to... as a standard action, cast Dancing Chains. Four of the chains with the chain devil's body spring to life and attack Flux. How do these...
essentially count as his attacks.
Yeah. So his attack was...
his attack was spike chain damage.
No, it counts as his damage, since his damage is already chain damage. One of those actually hit.
Yes, one hit Flux, one hit him.
One hit me.
27.
And 9 damage.
And Nut doesn't get their damage reduction. Off.
Okay. And as his turn ends...
get wrecked, chain boy.
So, the extra widened part of the portals begin to fluctuate, and this pops out.
Really?
What's that?
Do I know what that is?
We don't know, as characters, we don't know what shit is.
Yeah.
Hey, Zahn, if you're planning on going to...
I see boobies. Barra happy.
Is, like, the best chance for it?
First, I have to get there. And currently, I'm being body blocked by not only my enemies, but by my allies.
You can pass through your allies in combat.
I believe these limerers actually count for the requirement, too, because they're technically demons or devils.
And then it's initiative. All right. Ba-doop, 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 ba-doop. Zahn.
Take rut.
Got nowhere to go because I want to go forward.
I should do chain golem because it's dead now.
You can shift through us. You just have to take op attacks from the enemies to get up there.
Or you can keep trying to hit that guy over there.
So what, like I can move here?
No.
No,
exactly. That's what I'm like.
You can try and hit him. You can try and hit him. You can try and hit him. You can shift down this way through Neotag.
Think back. It's just like just when we...
You can shift down that way.
Think back. It's just like when we punch those bear cubs. Just need to take them out and keep moving.
Just need to kill more babies. Kill more baby bears.
I make a lance attack against the same thing that... That thing.
Okay.
Remember, your horse can attack.
And you hit.
All right. That kill it.
Hang on, I gotta do quick maths. No. But it's looking like a sad pile of goop.
Yeah, I know my horse can attack.
What damage direct? Never mind.
That's what I asked. Can't your horse attack?
They have damage reduction 5. I've been forgetting to calculate that till now, but yeah, they have damage reduction 5.
So I miss it by literally 1.
Yeah, he is literally now sitting at 8 of his 9 HP.
Then I raise my shield block against this one.
Okay. Okay, the new arrival gets to move.
Wait, what? As in a new arrival, don't they have to wait till the next set of turns?
They're out of the portal, probably stepping into combat knowing what's going on.
Yeah, they're coming out of combat knowing what's coming into combat knowing what's going on. Essentially, I'm ruling that they've rolled their initiatives on the other side of the portal, and this is the turns that they're popping in.
See, Neotech, they were told it was on the other side.
They were told that today was the day shit was going down. There was a meeting about it and memos and everything.
Zahn, do you really want the... That doesn't help you move, though. Only could do this spell 3 more times because I only have the components for it, so I'm trying to be careful with it.
All right, Flux. The new arrival shifts to here, pulls out a bow, and fires at you. I mean, I know, Flux, that could make things interesting, but...
You don't want to take it to that level.
I don't. Actually, it can't.
Yeah, it can.
No.
No.
Why can't it?
Oh, wait, no, hang on. Actually, would that work? That is not person Flux, though. That is monster. So I don't know if that... No, actually, no, that does apply to you because you're aware of
monster functions like person, except it's not restricted to type or size.
Yeah, fair enough. I don't want to take it to the point where Cromwell gets charmed by a demoness and starts turning on everybody. All right, what is there? All right, so it's shooting to hit Flux.
You hit.
All right. And it's damage.
That goes
through. And 1d6 fire damage because it's a flaming longbow.
Okay, that's 8 of that.
And now does Flux start?
Hey, Bay. How you doing, Bay?
Okay, you're going to take Ops of Opportunity through the 4 chains.
I don't believe I actually do.
I mean, they're there and there's weapons.
Yeah, but he's not there, so he doesn't get up attacks as being
Oh,
there.
Fine, whatever.
I mean, even if they did hit, they're not going to hurt me.
Fine, it's difficult terrain, but you have enough move speed, it doesn't matter.
Yeah. So I'm going to charge the Aranese, or the random demon.
The Mormon demon. Miss.
Yeah. Okay.
And let the goop commence. When I, here we go. Against flux. Zahn. Oh, who cares? They all affectionately flail. No one gets hit. We've pretty much written these things off as mooks. Red, your turn.
This is taking far longer than Sovic thought. It's time to speed the battle up.
Yeah, yeah, I expected the Neotag to be throwing way more AoEs around than he has. He's been more conservative.
All my AoEs are fire-based.
Because you're stupid. Oh.
You don't have,
the only one I have that's not...
to... Lightning, acid...
No, not till next level.
Okay, so I'm moving there. Yes, I know I'd take a bunch of... Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, they all miss.
6 attacks opportunities. They can't hit me. Fuck it. I'm hitting this guy right here.
And he's probably dead.
Frankly, you could tumble.
And 15, that hits, probably.
Yeah, that hits. He's dead.
Okay, he's dead because of sneak attack damage still. Because I'm still blinked.
Yeah.
Because
so
even if they, yeah, even they, if they hit me AC, they care. Still have...
They're immune to fire, they're immune to poison, and they resist acid and cold 10.
Yeah, see, all...
The Chain Golem was actually completely immune to magic.
Dude, all my AoEs are either cold or fucking fire right
now. Yeah.
Except for that one I just used to take out 3.
Yeah.
It's not
I thought you had a wider variety of elements and that this was going to be more fun.
It's not till level 3 that I get fucking, Ice Storm and Lightning Bolt.
I was hoping this fight was going to be Elemental Roulette where you kept trying to figure out what was the one bullet that would work.
Well, I mean, next level I'll have Chain Missile and it wouldn't my fucking matter, but it's too late for
whatever, it's your turn. Kill things.
Okay,
I would very much like to get one to one of those things up there.
I mean, kill one, probably focus it there and murder all those.
Yeah, I was wondering, kill more mobs or attack the two bosses?
I'll go with the mobs.
Okay, fine.
Less things to deal with.
I will point out, now the red fox is behind me, I can't be flanked, so literally the mobs can't affect me.
Alright, fine.
That's the only worry, right, the mobs will be flankers.
17, yeah, they're dead.
We're fighting back to back, brothers.
And the only reason I don't like using Hail of Stone is it's the only spell I have that has a definitive cost to it. I have to spend J-chips.
Against Chain Devil.
Okay. There you miss.
Dude, right. 2 that one to 1. What the fuck?
You hit yourself?
Alright.
Oh god, I just had a thought. Botching.
I don't have a botch table or anything set up yet, so it doesn't matter.
Whew!
If you shoot immediately into Zontors and it dies.
Alright, it is going to attempt to hit Red Fox with its 4 chains that are behind him.
No, I totally agree with you, Stovic. If it was next level, I'd be throwing lightning bolts everywhere.
Nope.
Formula Fox said Stovic.
Nope.
Doran, best country. Look at you, mage, compared to Doran.
I still have a higher kill count.
It is going to stare at Flux.
What?
You have to make a will DC 15 as its face resembles that of an opponent's departed loved one or bitter enemy.
Oh, you gotta bring tricks into here. Wasn't enough that you brought your girlfriend.
Will save time. You pass the will save. It is now back to just being a chainy face with red eyes.
I killed that lover.
I killed that bitch myself.
Oh, wait, did I just confess that? You did.
I killed that bitch for exile from the country. All right, that's its turn. Zahn.
I'm debating either to circle around or just keep kind of go through.
Just go through.
Yeah, all right. Okay.
Hooray! Well, crit.
Yeah, so.
Crits be popping. You confirm the crit on the guy with one health.
Oh, God.
So I do a...
He explodes!
Yeah, he dies.
We all have our own battles, and Zahn is with this one annoying lemur.
Zahn is just trying to hit this lemur, and it's just gooping around his spear like, rah! Yeah! This keeps moving just out of range like some cartoon thing. It's like the fucking Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel at Pegasus with the two who just kept dodging everything. Alright, yeah. Flux. She drops her bow as a free action, draws her sword, and attempts to hit you.
I'm gonna grab that bow.
Bar, you're gonna want to grab that bow and have it. It sounds like a good bow.
Oh, it does. I want that bow.
Fortunately, you might be doing more damage with your current one, though.
And I'll take a look at it.
Well, but he'll still get the extra fire damage. Yeah. And it's a plus 5 strength longbow, so.
So I still have the plus 3 bonus to my strength bonus damage. Nice.
13 damage. And now it is Flux's turn.
My turn. Full attack.
And now you badger her with blows.
Not gonna lie, I did not expect the entire session to be one big battle.
It was kind of like it with the last time. Remember?
I was expecting a bunch of social stuff and then maybe a small battle.
A miss.
Able to find rules for how a secondary attack technically counts, but whatever.
A hit?
I don't miss the fucking bite. Just gnawing on her face.
Put on. Claw dodge, bite. Oh fuck!
Fuck, wasn't expecting that.
God damn it! He's on my leg. Actually, no, she's technically naked. You probably just bit her on the boob. She's like, oh god, why would you do that?
Rip it off.
I wasn't protecting that part. Why would you ever do that? Who bites a boob?
No.
10 damage.
Okay.
Like, you kind of expecting the lemurs to start backing up and fucking trying to protect the portal and their bosses.
Why do you protect him? He doesn't care for you.
I mean,
be with a real man, baby.
Not gonna lie, he was the original boss, but she does outrank him.
I'm gonna take Duke Nukem style. I'm gonna comfort this lady with my masculine charm. Be with a real man.
You could try. I have stats for will saves here.
I'm gonna charisma check.
Make a charisma check.
Be with a real man, baby. Oh, sorry.
Never mind.
I'm trying to think like what the appropriate counter skill check would be.
Slap him in the face because he burped on her?
You know what? No, I'm going to say she has to roll concentration against whatever check he makes.
It turns out he burps a bit. Oh, sorry. That was a bit of you coming back up.
Wow. Come on.
Wow.
Session over. We can all go home.
Demons disappear. She just says, nope, you won. Leaves.
Nope, not dealing with this shit.
No.
Does she drop her bow?
Like, no, no, she just drops her sword and she's like, that's hot. she's a devil. She's into the weird shit. All right, now, are you seriously rolling a charisma check or anything?
That's what the 1d20 plus 2 was.
Okay, then let's do her concentration check to ignore you.
Can she? Oh god damn!
You don't even register on her radar.
That's why I killed the. That's why I killed the previous lover.
she tried to snub me. I'll snub her.
You want the cold shoulder? You'll get the cold shoulder.
Wait, how did Lemur get up there?
What are you doing there? What are you doing there, Lemur? Get down.
How the fuck's gonna... What? What? I mean, I think this turn order is still correct. Technically. Because Flux just went and it is their turn next, but I don't understand what happened.
Yeah, it's fine. It's still good.
Alright.
Hey, rat guy.
The one flanking Flux diagonal from the top is going to try to hit him.
You gotta be my wingman. Come on, it's cool.
The one flanking from the bottom will try to hit him.
Ah, oh, one might hit.
A crit. Check for your crit. Nope.
Still does damage.
It still does 3 damage.
And it does nothing. Doesn't.
All right, the ones that are not flanking will just flail at him. The one flanking red.
Hey, Red, you know you'll be real cool.
And a crit.
A tumble attack.
Well, you. I don't know how to handle this situation. You crit, and on your crit confirm, you roll a nat 1.
That doesn't matter.
Yeah, that just means he missed the crit. He still hits you, but he doesn't get the crit. Okay. You can't crit fail a crit check.
How many turns has it been since you activated your blade?
It is still in the third round. He has to roll a 50% percentile. He rolled a 73. And are you doing high or low on percentiles? I always forget. I'm doing higher is better. Okay. So, fine, you hit me. Can you roll more than 10 damage? No, then no. You don't do a fucking thing to me.
You both right. Have that bullshit.
Doran, best Doran.
All I can throw up is those. When we're right, in, nobody's, when we're in nobody's flanking's form, yeah. On, but they'll still try to hit him ineffectually.
You know, it'd be real cool, Red, if you could, like, tumble behind and start stabbing this girl.
I'm about to.
Thanks.
And one tries to hit Neotag.
I know for a fact the Chain Devil can't hurt
nope.
us.
Nope.
She can, but Chain Devil's, even at his max, he can't hurt us. Unless he crits.
Kai moves there. Just flails at Red. Another crit! Whoa, okay. Doesn't confirm. Nope. Where's that 100? Huh. Can't hit. Okay.
Has it really only been 3 rounds? Damn.
Yes. Yeah, it's only been 3 rounds. It's about to be the start of the 4th round. Is now flanking Cromwell. Crit? No.
Eager little beavers.
4 damage.
Oh, wow.
Man, you're just getting all the good numbers.
The
what the fuck?
Hit misses. Comes down, tries to hit Zahn. These guys just kind of come over and try to hit Neotag. A miss, a miss, a miss. Oh, wait, is that miss?
21 hits.
Four damage.
Ouch.
Hang on. I meant to hit Animus.
Good thing you have protective scales.
Oh. Tries to hit Kiri.
No. No. Also, would that actually be like an attack of opportunity to me?
No.
What about us? Yeah, if they're moving towards us, don't we get attack ops?
The only one that does is the one that just moved because they were not near you guys.
Yeah, that one just moved. And
the one that just moved past Zahn. Actually, no, it doesn't because Zahn has reach.
already moved into an area that I have reached, right?
Where was he initially?
He was initially next to Zahn.
Yeah, okay, no.
Yeah, he doesn't get an op.
Hit.
Does 20 hit Kiri?
Yeah, that hits.
4 damage.
Oh, I actually took damage.
And once more with the flanking on Fox. And now it's Red Fox's turn.
Yay! God damn it. You've plugged the hole. Alright, I'm gonna stab him.
You can tumble through them if you have a good enough tumble.
I do not have a good enough tumble. I'm gonna stab him.
Okay.
And yeah.
Hit and dead.
Hit and dead.
Stab and bite.
I'm gonna move there and take the attack, and I don't have to take the attack of opportunity because it's only a sidestep.
Right.
So that's it.
Fucked me.
Yeah.
I'm tired of killing mobs. I'm centering it here.
Okay.
14 damage on everything and all the chain, the woman, and the fucking thingy.
All right, hang on a second. All right, the Uranus completely ignores it. And
really?
The Chain Devil completely ignores it.
How?
Spell resist.
This is not spell resist.
Wait, how does spell resist work?
If the spell is... only spells that can be spell resist can work with that. It doesn't get... It's not a blanket.
Oh, fine.
I have it written down in case a spell is subject to spell resist or not. This one's not.
All right, fine. Then she only takes, because of damage reduction, 9 damage.
What's the spell you attack?
Hail of Stone. Just summon rocks and they just smash down on top of them.
And
not magical rocks. So they're not subject to spell resist.
Also takes 9 damage.
And the mook in front of Red Fox dies.
Yeah. Alright, Kiri.
Don't know if this works the way I think it does, but I'm going to be tumbling away right here.
I mean, I would say just do a 5-foot step, but
you could do a 5-foot step, and then you can do a full move action and then attack.
All right, so 5-foot step.
No, you can't. No, you only can shift. Yeah, that's right.
What's your tumble check?
My tumble check is...
What's your plus to it?
Yeah. Is it plus 4, plus 5,
it is
6, plus 10?
Plus 12.
You get away from them.
Yeah, I roll, and as long as
you tumble.
Three, as long as you get a 3, you tumble away from your normal move half your movement without the off attacks.
Oh, in that case, there, I can tumble and still attack, I believe.
Yep.
Yes.
So
that's why you tumble if you can.
So hitting this asshole.
I just want to imagine he shoots the bow while rolling.
He's pulling
19.
Yeah, all right, it's dead. He just never stops rolling and shooting. Shooting Stars just starts playing as he flies off into the distance.
Nah, you can't make anything that's JoJo awesome as that. Actually, no, I can't be anything as awesome as JoJo doing that.
Chain Devil. I was referring to the Palpatine one, but okay. Chain Devil's turn starts, and some of his flesh seems to grow back.
I miss having regen.
He's going to shift there and attempt to hit Red Fox with his chains.
Keyword is attempt.
But he's going to actually use his chains this time because he's angry.
And a nat one, and a nat one. Like I said, attempt is the key word.
He just kind of rattles his chains going,
table right now.
Spoopy. I'm really demoralized by the devil equivalent of having your manager called up front. Basically, that's actually what happened, essentially. The portal widened, and the air in his camp was like, the fuck just happened? What are you doing in here? How many limerous did you waste? I told you, you had 40 limerous to work with, and I hear you've killed, you lost how many? Zahn.
That was the most pathetic attack against me I've ever had.
I literally think he just rattled his chains going, ooh. Spoopy.
You know, you can always just drop your goddamn lance and get out your sword and just start swinging, right?
You can.
I guess I could.
Then you can pick up your lance later when you leave.
Okay. I guess that's what I do. I drop my lance. By throwing it at Cromwell. No.
Of my lance, it stabs through your horse, and your horse is dead.
Oh, that's amazing.
Drop the lance, roll a one, and it kills your horse. Which then falls over and kills your mare.
Okay.
I got the strength check to survive it.
I swing at the thing directly in front of me.
Yeah, but do you have the constitution to survive having the lemur smother your lance?
That's a crit. Because it's a longsword.
Yeah, I think it's like 18 or 19 that you need.
Yeah, it's 19. And I confirm it. Instead. Which one were you hitting?
I'm hitting the thing directly in front of me. Let me
Congratulations, Zond. You got 2 kills so far.
Hey. Actually,
3 kills. You have 3 kills so far, I think.
No. In this entire session or the entire series?
Oh, right. Entire series?
That is,
3.
That is Zond's turn?
The answer is yes.
And now back to the sword raptor fight.
I'm telling you, you're not going to win this. Just give in to my charm. Smell my manly musk.
And she gets to attack twice, so it's a full attack.
One
hits.
You know, both of them hit, I think. Yeah.
Both of them hit.
I'm about to say, I know you're a higher level than us, but I know you also have very little armor. Damn!
And you take 19 damage total.
Minus the 10.
I take no damage.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Flux. Wait, how do you take no damage?
Because it's a 9 and a 10. He has a damage reduction of 10.
Oh, it's a 9 and a 10. I wasn't paying attention to that.
Yeah.
I just heard 19. I'm going, well, that's 9. I didn't pay attention.
So what, was she trying to essentially feel his muscles or something?
I guess.
She swung so weakly it couldn't even cut his scales. So just kind of clanged off.
I'm going to suggest something since it's 11 o'clock now. Can we just say we've killed the mobs? And just focus on the two bosses at this point?
Yeah, the mobs are essentially dead at this point.
I'm going to full attack the Aranyi. Nope, and in the middle of that, I'm going to shift, and then the next full attack at the Aranyi's, and then a bite at the Aranyi's.
Nat 20.
Hey, you hit her. keep biting your boobs. Who does that? Seriously. Damage from
it's the only thing that works.
This good baby.
Well, it's better than white meat.
All right.
Well, I know what I'm doing on my next round.
Lemur dead.
Okay, look, this is turn.
And now it's Red Fox's turn.
This is turn for five.
Okay.
Some role playing. So.
So I'm going to do a full attack against her.
This is seduction against her at this point.
This is just
That's a 29 against her.
Yep.
So I'm also going to. I guess I'll roll that damage first. So that's going to be 13 damage against her. Then my second attack is.
About your sneak attack.
That's added in the damage I just rolled.
Okay.
This is my claw attack. Because I'm doing full-on attack here.
Full attack would be your dagger and your and a bite.
Just dagger and a bite? No, that's right, not two claw, yeah. So bite, I'm looking it up. Where the hell is my bite? Oh, it's right. I'm on the wrong sheet.
Are you small or medium-sized?
I am medium? Hold on.
Your bite's 20. So.
Hold on. Checking. I was on the wrong character sheet. Bite. It is a plus 5. Okay.
This is why you put little notes on the one character sheet instead of having to.
Does a 14 hit?
No.
So I had the opposite problem. My bite couldn't connect.
All right, Neo's turn.
Move to there. And let's try an orb of electricity. Range touch attack on the female.
Okay. Attempt to touch her.
Cop a nice feel.
A hit.
Unfortunately, you can't crit spells.
Yeah, magic don't crit.
That's what I was about to ask.
How many D8 is it? It's 5D8.
Is this Burning Hands?
No, this is Orb of Electricity.
Burning Hands, this would be bad.
Okay. She looks very singed and oddly aroused.
Why didn't he back off so much?
I don't know. She's playing Overwatch.
Go tell her you need to support your wife. Tell her that she's right. He should have backed off.
She's in the other room. She won't hear me.
Just shout across the house. You go, girl.
I try to avoid that at 11 at night. All right, so Kiri.
I just avoid playing Overwatch.
And I just... I mean,
Chain Devil.
I don't know why. Overwatch is fine.
Why can't I get anything beyond a 3 now?
And I'm just confirming, no, this is not subject to spell resist. So, yeah.
Chain Devil.
2-2 is a 1 and a 3. What the fuck?
Yeah. Alright, he's gonna try and hit you.
Try to hit Neotag. It's your best hope for damage.
Actually, yeah, she's gonna set the 4 chains against Neotag.
Look, I want you to look better to your manners because you're looking kind
of. Alright, one of those was a crit.
Uh oh.
And does the crit confirm?
Crit confirms and another one hit.
Alright, so let's do the normal. Just the crit first. So the first crit is.
There you go, dude. You just gotta believe in yourself. You can do this. If it makes you feel better, he was trying to burn down a
12 damage. So you're cool. And the second hit is 5 damage.
Ouch. I'm still at more than half health. Wait, what am I at? 22.
Look, at least...
And then he's gonna try and stare at Flux again.
At least he wasn't, like, phased, because, I mean, Tim the Chain Devil's really trying. Come on, dude.
Yeah, no, and he's going to try and stare at you again.
Oh, God, no, I didn't kill that one.
All right, you now take -2 on attack rolls for 1d3 rounds.
Why, Maria? Why did you leave me?
I mean, it could also be an enemy that just is blinding you at rage you can't hit straight.
Maria, I revealed to you that I killed my previous girlfriend as an act of confidence. Why'd you leave me after that?
We are learning so much about Cromwell today.
These are all jokes. This is not a fucking character for Cromwell. He's not OJ.
Oh! Wait, that makes no sense. Will DC 15 negates the save DC is charisma based? Does that just mean next turn you can make a charisma check to just cancel it early?
Wait, say that again?
charisma based?
No, what? Range, hang on, this is the exact thing word for word. Range 30 feet, will DC 15 negates. Chain Devil can make its face resemble one of an opponent's departed loved ones or bitter enemies. Those who fail the saves take a minus 2 penalty on attack rolls for 1d3 rounds. The save DC is charisma based.
It's for if the Chain Devil gets stronger. Its DC is increased by his charisma.
Oh, okay. So yeah. if I up his level.
Yes. Yeah. Then if you raise his level, it's based on his charisma.
Okay. Zon.
Well,
literally just move over one and then charge. Yeah, there you go.
Well, I don't have my lance. I don't get my charge bonus. Thanks to people recommending.
You still get a charge bonus with your sword.
You just don't get the times 4 crit.
Yeah.
Charge.
Which, frankly, fine, you really think you're going to crit?
And I charge.
You can't shift and charge. Charge is flat.
Oh, well, yeah. Then I can't. Then I just move there, then. Move
the yeah.
Why are people telling me to charge, then?
Roll your thing, because that gives you a bonus to hit.
But I can't charge.
Yeah. You can still charge without your lance, and you still get the bonus to hit. You just don't get the bonus to crit.
Just don't overcharge.
I thought
and
you could,
hit.
I thought you could make one move and then charge.
Charges a full
round
action.
No. Okay. Oh, 13 damage.
Does that actually hurt the thing, or?
Oh, yeah, no. Severely. Actually, I keep forgetting her damage reduction, too. Fuck it.
Too much damage reduction in this fucking campaign.
I almost never get to use things that have damage reduction, so I never think to check it.
And then I raise my shield against the Ares. See,
if I do quick math real quick, I think that makes her health actually this. If I give back the health from the damage reduction from Neotag's hit, and then take away the damage from Zahn's hit. So that it's still a net gain.
Yeah.
I'll tell you that much. And it's her turn.
What
as she's
of
looking
damage
at you,
reduction
Zon.
Is it?
It's just damage reduction 10. It gets bypassed by Silver and by Foley. Which frankly I think Flux does the Silver damage anyway.
No, my dagger does.
Oh, your dagger is? Nah, never mind then. So it's now going to attempt to hit Zon.
Okay.
If it wasn't for the fact that I don't want to take the time to pull out my silver dagger.
Nope.
And my current dagger is much better than my silver.
So Flux.
This is why I carry a silver dagger.
Let's see if we can keep the streak of nothing but bites going.
I laugh at the thing.
I know, I'm good with her. I need to dedicate my time to Tim. Tim feels like he's being severely underappreciated in this fight. So I'm going to turn to the chain. It's cool, Tim. I get that you're trying.
Page over to Tim.
I'm going to reciprocate Tim.
Bite one of the chains. Is this doing anything for you? A miss and a hit.
And a
bite. And the bite hits again.
He's tasted the white meat.
13 damage to Tim, which is now 8 damage to Tim.
Spit out like a rusty chain.
You just rip one of his chains off. He's like, ow, that hurt. I was attached to my nipple.
See, Tim, you know, you're a good guy, Tim. You're just being shown up by your boss. It's not cool. We understand.
I mean, he's actually in better shape than she is, technically, because no one's been trying to hit him.
Yeah, but she's gonna. Then you can't kill an outsider. They're just gonna go back, and it's gonna look bad on Tim's
role. All right, so
that's true. You've basically just been banishing these things. You haven't even really been killing them.
Actually, no, I am going to do another full attack.
They're minded soul.
So here's my swordy sword, which is a crit.
Hurrah!
So I'm going to. Confirm. Does that a crit confirm?
You did not confirm.
Okay. So that's still. That much damage, which that sucked. And
so she took 4 damage.
And I'm going to also bite. I guess not. So it's missing the bite for me constantly. And that's the end of my turn.
All right, Neotag.
I move there, and let's try. It worked last time. Touch hit.
Touch hits, I believe. Let me double check that. Yes.
Damage.
You murder her.
Yes. Yes.
You have shocked her to death.
This is what needs to happen. Caleb,
okay.
Let me take Tim through the portal.
She squicks all over the floor as she just crumbles and dies.
One down, Cromwell! Can you handle him alone?
Well, she's been banished back to hell, and there's just a pile of demon lady spooch on the ground now.
Except no items?
Didn't take the bow with her.
No, she dropped the bow and assorted things. Yes. All of her possessions dropped.
Yes!
Their body and soul are one, so there's no soul leaving when they die.
Alright.
Okay.
Special to your campaign.
Well, anyway, she's dead. Scary.
I assume we can just pretend that these two monsters aren't here.
Oh, I forgot too. Yeah, I did.
No, Kiri, this is your battle.
Since you were volunteering information, you wouldn't happen to give me the chain golem's resistances, would you?
To Tim.
Leave Tim alone.
First off, he's immune to magic.
I don't use magic. I'm using arrows.
I'm talking to Neotag.
He's just also completely immune to magic?
Yeah. Chain Golem is immune to magic as a construct, so has all construct traits, he's also immune to critical hits.
He's talking about the Chain Devil. He's talking about Tim.
Tim? No, you can't know about Tim.
Tim keeps the secrets close.
Tim plays for Days in the Maze, man.
I'm asking about Tim, since you were volunteering information earlier.
I was talking about the Golem.
Tim's got a classified record.
Tim was the Golem.
Tim's dad is some good.
All right, more. Tim's nipple grows back.
Look at you, Tim.
And he's going to attempt to hit Zahn with his chains.
Charisma. We need to convert Tim.
Looks like two hits.
Yep, two hits.
The Chain Devil, bro.
All right, she's dead, so I don't need her page open anymore. And he does 2d4 plus 2. 4 damage.
That's it?
Yep.
It's sad.
Now it's Zahn's turn.
Should move there. And I swing.
Swing and a miss.
And I raise my shield against him.
I think I feel.
And Flux. You get to go. Give him a minus finger. 2 to hit.
I'm going to start a charge. And I'm a bull rush Tim into the portal.
How do you charge take you standing? The portal?
It might. I'm up with these story ideas.
But you can charge standing? I thought you had to have at least 20 feet.
There's no need for a run up for a charge.
Well, not for a bull rush anyway.
Yeah.
Bull rush is basically you're just tackling him. Pretty much, yeah.
Actually, no, he's right.
He's literally just shoulder checking the guy into the portal.
I must move at least 10 feet to start a charge. Whatever. I can
still
rush him.
Well, bull rush is still bull rush.
Still bull rush.
Yeah. Fucker. All right, roll.
But he gets his op attack first.
Spooky chain. Spooky chain.
Spooky scary Tim.
She just changed chain devil to Tim.
And now we just do opposing strength checks. So, like.
Tim just rebuffs you with his pecs.
Tim, I gave you a chance to leave.
You bounce off Tim like, what the fuck, man? I thought we were friends.
Tim does the chest bump thing like, what do you want? What do you want?
I gave you a fucking chance to leave, Tim. You didn't take it.
You don't know me.
Step right. off.
I know, Tim. You've been hurt too bad. Let us feel you, Tim.
My turn?
Yeah, Red's turn.
Ow.
I'm actually starting to have an emotional attachment to this chain gun.
Alright. I'm gonna stab you with my sword.
I think he gets off that.
And you hit.
Yay! I thought I was going to miss on that one.
I mean, yeah, he does also get op attacks, but I think Red's just going to...
You killed him.
15 damage.
Actually, no, does that 29 hit you?
Yeah.
I mean, it does begin.
Roll percentile.
Nope.
Nope.
he hits one of the after images.
This is the start of turn 5 of 6.
All right, so that was what, 15 damage?
Yeah.
So that's 10 damage with his damage reduction.
Wait, it's turn 5.
Yeah, it's only attack. Turn 5.
I know. All those little guys ate up so much time.
It did.
Is there any supports for the portal, like any?
No, it is a floating mass of magic. There's nothing physically there.
Okay. Well, then I guess I'm just going to try and hit the chain devil with magic missile.
It's literally a tear in reality, just floating in the air, like 5 feet above the ground.
All right, 9 damage to him.
Okay. Kiri?
I've only got 3 more rounds of rage.
Come on!
And Tim's turn.
Why? Why am I getting shit rolls now?
Nipple back.
Push you in that portal, Tim. Whether you like it or not.
And the chains magically extend and start trying to hit Bara.
So, 2 of those hit.
No, he finally hit someone.
God, it's been so far. I can't scroll up to the...
Frankly, it should just be the damage Tim normally does.
Here it is. Yeah, it is, really... but I didn't want to type it, so I was scrolling up to it, and then, like, as a challenge, I kept trying to get up to it. All right, you take a 9 and a 7.
So that's 16 damage.
Does the chain just reach out for your nipples?
Got a little nipple envy.
Those chains have such sights to show, Bara.
Oh my.
No, chain devil senpai.
Well, I have pierced nipples now.
So,
yeah, as the chains are still attached to the dead chain golem. You get to attack with as many attacks as you're possibly able to in a given round while giving up all other actions.
Oh, okay.
Which you only have one, so.
Yeah, you only have one, so there's no point.
It comes with things, you have better BAB or extra attacks.
Ooh.
Like Red Fox do.
Yeah, if I put my can do 3 attacks.
So
no, he hit.
Well, I got a crit. I was confirming.
Oh,
crit.
The 27. Yeah, 27 hits. Crit doesn't hit. 12.
And I raise my shield against him.
Okay.
And raise my middle finger against him.
Flux.
God, how is he not dead?
It's almost like he brought this upon yourself.
I don't know. Maybe it's like he has regeneration or something.
And shit rolls on my part.
Make his op attacks with bull rushing him again. Look, Tim, you were the one who decided that my attacks needed to be debuffed, so now I'm just gonna start bull rushing.
I do believe those hit.
They do. Somehow he can make 2d4 plus 2, get anything over the 10, and cheat the system.
Okay, now the strength check.
Now strength checks. There's no fucking way you're critting again, Tim.
God damn it!
God damn it, again!
No.
Yeah, fuck you.
Fuck you, Tim. We both go in the portal.
Oh, God, no.
Wait, really?
Tim,
no. Tim. Skill check, Tim. He crit. He automatically wins, doesn't he?
No.
No.
No, there are no crits in skill checks. This is the 4th edition.
I pushed him back 10 feet, and I'd go with him.
Wait, what?
Yeah, no, Flux is in the portal now.
Oh, dear.
I mean, I could have stopped, but I mean, this is more fun.
Well, welcome to the outer layer of hell, Flux. You're apparently now sitting in the middle of a massive devil garrison on the outermost layer of the 9 hells.
Hey, guys, I brought Tim back.
The portal is still open behind you.
See, I wanted to go to hell. I just didn't want to wait in line to get here, so I took the...
There's also a pedestal with a stone on it, and the stone's shooting a red light at the portal.
Huh, cool. Well, that was my turn, though.
Red?
All right,
Gary, this would be the time for you to shoot an arrow.
I am going to... I hate this. I am going to...
Red, I also want to point out there's a pit fiend about 200 feet away from you, just slowly staring in your direction as he notices you came through. Well, to me, like a slow, what the fuck kind of turn.
I am going to drop my dagger, which instantly removes my blink. I am going to pull out my short bow.
Wait, rogue blade isn't a dagger, it's a rap. It's a rapier.
Or a rapier, yeah, whatever.
I heard you.
He's been wielding dagger. Flux this whole time.
Yeah. And I am going to shoot at the orb.
Can we make sure that our team member is back on the other
no,
side?
No, this is too big. If he wants to go through the portal, he can stay.
Can Red even see the orb because he's not inside the portal?
If Red doesn't hit it, I'm fucking...
He cannot actually see the orb.
Oh, okay, then never mind then. I thought
all,
I could
see all you can see through the portal is fire.
All right, then I don't know what I'm going to do then. I am going to...
Can we just assume I'm going to be cycling through everyone's turns as they stare confused until
no.
The Chain Devil's turn?
No.
Hold on. Spot, right? Yeah. I'll make a spot check to see if I can find any way of disabling this portal.
Okay. There is nothing on this side apparently interacting with the portal.
Shit.
If only those elves would have been here.
All right, that's the end of my turn.
You got a tag?
You only live once! Funk.
Wow, you're dumb.
Right, you tag. You have now garnered the full attention of that pit fiend who was only staring at curiosity before. It's like, okay, what's going on here now?
I looked around.
He said it was like 200 feet away.
I know. I got this planned. Let me speak. Cromwell, get through the portal. Did you see anything powering it real quick?
Well, you have to wait for his turn to talk.
Sorry, I was in Tim's packs.
No, you can have short conversations between characters, can't you?
Isn't that like a free action?
Yes. I didn't see anything. I've been staring at Tim.
I look around real quick. Do I see anything?
You do see the little gem.
His pecs are oiled.
I grab the gem. And
I mean, it's a good, like, 10 feet away.
Would it take me to go in?
So you'd have to finish all your right. move to it.
All right, I still have 15, so I'm get to the gym, and then I can double move. I look at Cromwell.
Because getting the
no,
gym is
picking
a
up picking
action.
Up the gym was a standard action because you actually had to physically pry the gym out. It wasn't just loose there where you just picked it up as a free action. That was a standard action to just like physically pry it out of the stone.
All right, I grab the gem, and then that's the end
of
my turn.
The portal slowly starts to close. In dramatic fashion.
All right.
Almost like an eyeball just kind
of... I'm going to yell to Cromwell, we getting out of here!
Get to the chopper!
I wanted to
get
sign up.
Get to the portal!
I wanted to sign up.
Okay, Kiri.
All right. Call it insane, like, well, but this is what I'm going to try and do. I'm going to do a double move. No, actually,
no,
I can't do that shit.
No, right I mean...
I was thinking about grabbing it. Yeah, I was thinking of grabbing Zahn's lance and using that as like a stick to try and grab you guys out.
So we can just cross over. Dude.
Okay, you can try that, but I'm not gonna lie, that is going to be super ineffectual, and it may or may not result in the portal just sucking you through.
May or may not result in you sticking a lance through and immediately stabbing one of us because you can't.
Yeah, yeah, that too.
I just move up here.
You pick up the Lambo.
He just moves up there and looks dramatically. Tim's turn.
You battle with your people, Tim. You can be thankful.
Well, to be fair, could I even see Tim?
Tim's going down fighting.
Tim acknowledges that if he doesn't kill this goddamn raptor, he's going to hear no end to it.
If he doesn't kill you, that pit fiend's coming for him next.
Yeah, he's going into the lava. He doesn't want to live in the lava, okay?
Okay, so Tim hits, and again, he can't scratch me.
He doesn't want to join Lefestus in the giant glacier.
Yeah.
All right, Zahn.
We
really do need to wrap this up.
I know.
That's what I'm trying to do. Can we just assume we go to Flux and then my turn?
Yeah, let's just assume Zahn's doing nothing. Flux?
I'm going to blow a kiss to Tim and do a full withdrawal.
And I fuck it. I have the orb and I book it out of the portal and I'm gone.
Right, yeah. Okay. As it closes, Tim comes back out and it closes behind him.
God damn it, dumbass!
Tim!
Tim is dead alive.
Everyone else has given up their ability to fight because they all kind of relaxed, like, what the fuck's going on? So you got the whole initiative again next turn.
Look, I don't recall ever saying you. That I was relaxed.
But we kind
of, yeah, DM's prerogative. You all relaxed.
Yeah. All right, I roll a 6.
Because I decided only after I delete every position. You know what? No, Tim falls through.
Tim, welcome back.
Tim's desperate to get one of us. 25. Okay, that's all it comes down to. If he wasn't fucking immune to fire, I'd pull out my nuke spell, but I can't right now.
Alright, Kiri, care to roll again?
Roll the 6 or something.
Twice in a row!
You know what, fuck, I don't have time to change the spell checking. Your name's now Kree.
Kree!
Alright, so it was Tim's turn, so now Zahn's turn.
Alright. I swing at the thing devil and be like, what? And I... No, that's not a crit.
I have to imagine the portal is slowly destroying itself as we watch.
It basically closed like an eyeball slowly closing to go to sleep.
Tim jumped down. All right. His eyeballs.
Zahn actually managed to hit and do 12 damage to Tim.
Yep.
Tim needs to die already.
Please die.
All right, Flux.
I'm going to roll a diplomacy check to bring Tim to our side.
God damn it.
Tim, you've got nowhere else. Come to our side.
I mean, you make a compelling argument, but let's see if Tim can make a charisma check against that.
Somehow I don't think the elves outside will let him live.
Will defend Tim to the death.
Tim's counter argument is I must kill or die.
Tim, that's not a life you live anymore. You can give up that life.
Anything else you want to do, Flux?
I mean, that's my attempt. I'm not killing Tim. I'm gonna bring.
All right, Kiri.
Feet and going to the chain devil. And
not
please...
gonna lie, if Flux manages to roll high enough, I am going to allow him to convert Tim.
Tim has been through more than what with me.
Oh, please be something higher than a 3 or a 4.
You roll a 1.
You roll a 20. You just managed to hit his AC on.
Oh!
The big bar just squelched. Sweet accuracy.
17!
Alright, 17, take away 5 is 12. Alright.
Please be enough, Tim, please be enough.
Tim ain't looking so good. Tim's kind of like, okay. Like, hey.
New attack. Stop hurting him. He's a peaceful giant.
I can do this.
I did not mean to roll that.
Point.
That's not what I needed to roll, by the way.
Tim's just sitting there punch drunk, like, come on, I can take it.
I'm trying to do...
Back and forth with his fists in front of him.
Attack diplomacy him. He's a good man.
Yeah, sure he is.
He's misunderstood. He's picked on.
I mean, at this point, he knows he can't kill you guys, so you could probably imprison him if you do.
Does that hit his touch AC, the 14?
Yes.
Tim in the song.
I already don't like you, Neotag. If you killed him, we might come to blows.
27 cold damage?
Ooh, cold damage, you say?
He's just not resistant.
Well, he ignores it.
Ah, I thought you said he had immunity of fire and resistance to cold, like 10.
No, that was the Lemurs.
Okay, fuck it.
He's immune to cold.
So he's immune to fire, cold.
No, he's just immune to cold.
Oh, he's also immune to fire.
Yeah, it was the
Don't
lady
forget,
that
there's
was
more
immune.
Than one hell. Not all of them are fire.
My yeah, God, stop then being I would Christian. Have daughter, then I would have done Scorching Ray like 20 turns ago.
I know you would have. That's why I mixed the damage reductions and immunities.
If only there was some kind of small fox creature that could have told us the...
Yes, if only he was still around right, or Red. Ever did that.
Bring it on home, Red.
All right, let's do this. Stabby mix, stab, stab.
Okay, you stabbed.
For a...
Your crown prince demands this. Don't kill him.
Leave him alone.
For a 10. And a bite of...
Come on, whiff for old time's sake.
13.
And you whiff.
God damn it, I keep whiffing on the bite.
Okay,
look,
the best
you're
thing about...
the raptor. He has a better bite attack, okay?
Wait. I have a question.
So, here's the funny thing is...
Question.
Yeah?
My weapon roll that I've been doing is considered magic.
Okay.
Or it's a magically enhanced
That
weapon.
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't
okay.
matter.
Just wanted to make sure about that. It's like, wait a sec.
So,
this weapon's magic.
Interesting development here, Flux. That brought Tim down, but Tim ain't dead.
Damn.
Tim's at -2. Now, Zahn. He is helpless. It is your turn, and you are honor bound by your class to not murder a helpless foe, even if it is a devil.
I need a medic. I've already have my diplomacy roll right here.
Okay,
I surrender.
He's just going to regenerate and come back next turn.
Whoa!
Jesus Christ!
Fucking hell!
I think
literally fails to think of a response to this and simply bows his head in defeat, knowing that he could not defeat you, and that going back to the nine hells is a death sentence worse than death itself.
Sovek, you do realize that due to his action, that's 1.5 times experience for subjugation.
That is. Well, no, he made him surrender. He didn't subjugate him.
That's technically subjugation.
Well, no, he's not making
for the rules. For the rules of XP, that is, it's 1.5 times now because he surrendered.
Oh, it's extra XP. Okay, no, I thought you were talking like Zong gets a penalty for having subjugated someone.
No.
Okay. Yeah, no, you get bonus XP off the encounter because you made the Chain Devil surrender piece.
All right. Before we end the session and divvy up XP, what treasure was left behind besides the Chain Devil?
I'm actually gonna have to roll for that because both the Chain Devil and the Irinus, on top of the Irinus's bow and some rope, drop standard treasure for the encounter.
And before we do that, we're gonna stabilize Tim.
No, we're not.
I mean, Tim automatically just stabilized himself from regeneration.
Not before I had a chance to stabilize him. So
no, he regenerates automatically.
Let's just get the XP out of the way because I really do need to get going.
20 to stabilize Tim.
Oh, Jesus. I'm actually going to have to do the... I have to do the mooks in two separate categories because the encounter category only goes up to 20 for a number of monsters.
Yeah, you kind of
went a little overboard.
Yeah. And here's the thing, Utag.
Here's the thing. They're only encounter level 1, so I knew you would just murder the shit out of them.
Well, the problem is you thought I had level 3 spells. I only have level 2.
All right, so the Chain Devil was a CR 6.
Nita, here's the thing. Tim will regenerate, but on his turn. So when my turn comes around, I stabilize him. Now he can
The Aranus was CR 8.
And you have to remember...
If somehow we... And the Golem was a 5, I believe.
Well, everyone but Flux and...
I'm going to point out there are rules for playing a chain Devil. And I might have to give up your challenge of playing my part in your tag. Now we have Tim. I might have to play Tim.
You may have to give Tim a backstory and a purpose in life. Yeah.
Somehow I think...
I don't think there's actually a way to add in the bonus percentages there.
No, you have to do it in
your
head.
You have to do it. Yeah, you got to do it in your head.
Okay. So three of you are level 5?
Yeah. Yes, we were...
Yeah.
All right, Red Fox, what is your effective level?
8.
And Flux is still a 7, I believe?
Yep.
All right, calculate. And then everyone multiplies this their total by 1.5.
What was that number again? I just missed it.
By 50%.
Yeah. No, the initial
so
number.
I haven't given the number yet.
Oh, fuck.
All right, Zahn, Kiri, and Neotag get 4,050 times 1.5.
$9,112.5. So is that 11 or 13?
No, that's wrong.
That is very wrong. That is very wrong, sir.
You're getting 6,075.
Oh, he said 0.5. Oh, okay, I heard it's 1.5.
Yes. No.
Yeah. Yes.
6,750, dude. We're level 6 and we're halfway to level 7.
No, 6,075, not 6,750.
That's what I got when I did it, dude. It's 6,750.
Okay, then I'm doing math wrong because I'm getting different numbers.
4,500 times 1.5.
No, not 4,500.
Is 6,075.
4,050.
Okay, 6,075 is what I did.
4,050.
Oh.
6,075.
Yeah. You know, I'm just gonna do the math because I apparently can't trust anyone.
Apparently not.
Try to cheat, he gets 1.
All right, now for Red Fox.
And
for
trying to kill him.
Red Fox gains 3,720.
3,720.
Did you say 60?
Is that before or after?
That is after multiplications.
Okay.
And lastly, $48.30 for Flux. That was an encounter level 12, difficulty overpowering.
Finally got an extra level.
Yay.
You're finally level 5.
The treasure that was dropped in gold value, the non-magic shit, I haven't rolled for magic yet, I can do that while people who want to leave can leave.
Yeah.
But as far as money goes, money-wise, they dropped loot worth 10,582 gold.
So... 10,000 what?
582.
Divided by how many of us?
Five. Oh, yeah, 5. I was counting in Tim.
Don't give Tim back any of his wealth.
Okay, so that's 2,116 gold and 4 silver.
Now, as for
each of us,
special loot, because there is going to be some special loot.
I've got my pad open. I'm trying to deal with the experience, but yeah, I got the pad open.
216.4.
The Aranist, on top of the money that she dropped, also dropped rope. Just normal-ass rope.
Weird.
50 feet of it.
Yeah, I don't need it. I got tons and tons and tons of rope.
I'm just writing everything down, dude.
Yeah. And a plus 1 flaming composite longbow plus 5 strength bonus.
I think I like that.
You can't use it without penalty. It's plus five. Yeah.
You literally cannot pull the string back all the way.
Yeah, I can't use it either.
You can't even, like, restring it if somehow it ever got unstrung.
I can use
it. Flux, on the other hand, I think could use it.
I can use it.
No, I'm writing it down right now. We'll divvy it up after he lists right. everything.
You're also welcome to sell it. Yeah, and now I'm going to pull out books to sort out the rest of the loot. So this is normally when I probably would have dropped something like cool and fancy, but I was actually not prepared for tonight, and I literally came up with all this like at the last minute, in the last hour before we started. So
plus one composite longbow with a plus five strength modifier.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's what it is. Yeah. It's worth it's a plus two weapon. It's worth about 9,000 gold.
So we're not gonna remember which.
I'll take it. I need a ratio.
Which page is the fucking magic divvying up on?
You get, take it.
Man, I've got a plus eight to hit when I'm in my hybrid form.
Unfortunately, Kiri, we give it to you, but you can't use it. It's plus five. They're right. You actually cannot pull it back. You can't even use it.
Yeah.
You have to have the strength.
You are physically not strong enough.
You have to have a plus five strength modifier to use this thing.
It's a flaming plus five composite longbow.
Yes.
But I'm not a plus five.
A plus one flaming composite longbow.
All right, I'm gonna roll the D100 for
strength modifier
for items.
All right, let me get this thing to write down. I just finished with the experience. Okay, I got it. I'm ready. And Flux already has his bow, so I'm deleting that from the list. All right.
You roll a 41 on the table, which is 1d6 minor magic items. Two minor magic items.
I have a plus 10 to hit with this longbow, then. I'm gonna be the archer now.
Beep, beep, I'm throw my bow around.
Beep, beep, I need some arrows.
Well, you don't get the skirmish bonus. You get the flaming damage, and you get a plus five.
Oh, yeah, I also have to roll for goods, because that only counted for gold. So 52.
It turns out Tim was holding some flowers.
Which is 1d10 gems.
More gems for me to write down.
Four gems.
We just put them in a gold. Oh, no.
Let me roll for the four gems. Forty-two is 50 gold bloodstone.
My notes section is filled.
100 gold silver pearl. Uh, 50 gold rose quartz. And a 500 gold black pearl.
Pirate ship?
No, sadly.
I wanted Jeffrey Rush to fight for us. Where does Chain Devil go over at him?
Table 7-1.
We currently have 1,700 in gems. We have 1,000.
Mm-hmm.
Golden gems plus what we just got.
Both of those fit in the same category of minor magic items. So you got a pair of scrolls.
Pair of scrolls.
I'll take those.
How about you let the magic guy hold on to the scrolls?
Nope. I'm starting a multi-class. I'm your archer, and now I'm also a wizard.
No, Ymir is holding on to the scrolls.
I am the everything raptor. I'm the truth version of a Renaissance man.
I am the everything raptor. Yeah.
Do we know what they're in the scrolls, or are they just...
Hang on, I'm working on that.
Okay.
Why don't you open it up and check, Neotag?
Because I know better.
Scroll, blessed rune.
One arcane scroll and one divine scroll.
One I can use and one I can't use.
The arcane scroll with a 69.
Let me see.
Is a second level scroll.
Good thing is Tim's a
cleric,
so he can use the scroll.
Eagle Splendor. The divine one is another second level scroll. Let me find the divines.
I'm gonna spell these right when I'm after you're done.
Chill metal.
All right,
and
that is
Is your loot.
Okay. Fortunately, the only thing that was useful is the bow.
Which goes to the one guy who probably didn't need it.
The fact that I have a ranged weapon now is pretty good.
It's amazing you have a ranged weapon, but frankly, you're like the least person in the party in need of a weapon upgrade.
No, the fact that I didn't like min-max Cromwell that much just means he's actually pretty decent ranged.
No, he's saying you're already set for weapons. Everyone else isn't.
I'm basically saying, Flux, that out of everyone here, you're doing okay at what you did. It was really Zahn and Kiri that could have used the weapon drop.
Okay, so here, Kiri, I'm going to chuck my greatsword at him. Here you go. You kid.
Look, what we'll do is we'll teach Zahn how to monkey grip and then give him the greatsword.
You're all right, Mean Joe Green. Thank you.
I mean, you could literally just downgrade it to a strength of 3 and let him use it.
I don't know if you can do that once it's been made magical.
Nope. It's composite longbow.
So I'm saying you could DR rule it. That's what DM rule is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
It's not what Aranese use.
Yeah. No, Aranese, because of the fact that they do have a +5 strength, can do that.
All right.
There would be no reason for them to have a weaker bow.
I should have given my number to all those devil checks.
Actually, you know what? I want to do something fun here for a second.
So, Kiri, Zahn, and me are level 6, halfway to 7.
Oh, we're level 6 now.
Yes.
Yep.
Our experience total is 1,800,275.
Okay. Did I miss anything good?
Not really. It was a bunch of jewels and a couple of scrolls. Yeah, we didn't get jack shit, really. I mean, we're going to sell it all and make a little profit, but it's not going to be that much.
Well, Stabby McSqueak Squeak is happy now. He's gotten money.
And between the jewels, the jewel crown worth 6,000, the 1,000 gold in random gems, we now have shit we need to sell. We have about 10,000 worth of gold of shit we need to sell, which we can't sell. We got a handy haversack. We got masterwork thieves tools, the gold crown.
No, we got the bag of holding type 4.
Yeah, but
it's type 4.
Yes, a long time. Yes, that's what Zahn has.
Oh yeah,
and he gave me the handy haversack. Because he didn't need it anymore. And he can't put a bag
you were,
of holding.
I thought you were talking about things we just got.
No, I'm talking about all the stuff that's that Ymir's basically been holding on to for the party. We've got about 10,000 in items that we need to offload pretty soon.
Also, by the way, just to give you a little bit of a clue onto all I'm carrying. I have two bags of holding.
I know. And
in the bags of holding, I have a bedroll, 50 sets of caltrops, a climber's kit, a grappling hook, one 10-foot ladder, some flint and steel, three 24-foot ladders, a portable ram, six spades, 15 segments of 50 feet of silk rope, five fishing nets, a crowbar, a cold weather outfit, and 180 arrows. So, yeah, I have a lot of stuff in there.
Okay, I've got a bag of holding type one. That's where I've been keeping our loot.
Yeah, I still need to actually, I need
except
to
except for
the
haversack, which is, well, the loot we just got, a loot we got before is, except for the crown, is all sitting back at my
Flux,
house.
I have a question. Did you try to activate the bow when you picked it up to test it?
No. I just took it.
Okay.
I picked up the bow and was like, hey, can you use this bar? And Bar was like, oh, I'm not strong enough. And you said, hey, give it here.
Give it
and I threw
it
to you.
Hold in so that I could use it. Why is it okay. An evil bow, Simic?
Yeah, as soon as you pulled it back to try and use it, Flux, you find that you feel compelled to not put it down.
Okay.
You also feel a rising bloodlust inside of you.
I'm gonna take the bowstring and kind of wrap it around my shoulder, so it's technically still on me, and I've now got it under my, like, I've had the bowstring under my armpit.
You are physically incapable of letting go of the bow to do so.
Ah, you son of a bitch. It's the rules, Lair Bow.
Oh no, you can't melee right now.
I'm gonna grab my dagger, and I'm gonna cut the bow apart, so there's only the
you
little
can't.
Bit on my hand.
You can't.
No.
Wow, no. With my coins, I'm actually at a medium load. I need to switch them over to my...
Flux, you know what... Flux, you do subconsciously know what will satisfy the bow.
And I do, but I'm also a dick. So you said I can't put down the bow. I'm not putting down the bow. I'm cutting the bow.
The bow breaks your knife.
Bullshit. You're a dick bow. I'm going to start bashing the bow against a wall.
The bow keeps insisting in your mind that blood be shed.
Nope. Bashing the bow against the wall till the side breaks.
Nope.
And keep bashing. You're not gonna stop me.
Are you having some issue?
Either the bow breaks or the wall breaks, in which case we've got a great pickaxe now. Give me my welcome, Zovic. Which one do you want to give me?
Your fist breaks. But still holding the bow.
Okay, I see what must happen now.
There is an easy out to this.
Bloodshed has been spilt. He has broken his hand.
Actually, blood.
Actually, as soon as your hand is bloodied, the bow lets you let go of it and put it away.
No, this is not over. Give me that bow back.
Yeah, you now know that every time you draw the bow, you are compelled and physically unable to put the bow away and cease using it. Once intention to use it has been made, until it has drawn blood.
Yuri, you want a bow?
So, but essentially, Cromwell could use
I'll it
in like
to sell
fight,
it. I can't
kill
use it.
With it, and then put the bow back.
Do you know what? No, I'm gonna give the bow to Tim. Here you go, Tim.
No, hang on, I need to see what the next thing that happens is.
Tim gets the bow.
No. You still have the bow.
No, I think that's the only thing that happens.
No, there's no fucking rule where you're saying I can't give it away. I'm giving the bow to Tim. There's nothing rules to say I can't give it away. Here you go, Tim. You can have a bow.
Keep in mind, we gotta feat this level, Zahn and Kiri.
Yeah, I know.
Yep.
I don't know what I'm gonna do yet.
I'm gonna take... You know what? I think I'm going to go with Flux's idea, and I think I might multi-class into the Hell Reaver. So I can take power
attack in the next level, I'll take another two ranks in the Knowledge of Planes, and then level after that, I can take Hellreaver.
I mean, you get skill points anyway, so you can go ahead and do that if you want.
I have removed it from my possessions. It's now
in. Well, I've already put my skill points into it. I need another level too.
Tim is a DM-controlled character right now. You can't force him to do anything.
Okay, but I can give him the bow. Here's your bow.
No, you can't.
Why not?
There is one last drawback to this bow. It causes selfish possessiveness to whoever activates it.
Mm-hmm.
You are now selfishly possessive of that bow.
It's my bow, Tim. Fuck you. Cut you.
No, you feel compelled that no one else is ever allowed to have or use this bow.
Good thing I didn't try to pick it up.
Oh, I touched the bow, but I didn't try to draw it, and Bara wasn't able to.
Actually, no, Bara tried to draw it, so I'd be trying to use it. Put this shit on Bara.
Yeah, but Bara wasn't able to successfully draw the string. So he didn't actually activate the bow. Because you successfully pulled the string back, you showed the bow that you were capable of wielding, which triggered the curse.
Somebody's strong. They're worthy. So, are we getting anything else, or is that it?
No, that's it. That's your shit.
No, you can use a composite longbow that you don't reach the strength of, so he could have pulled it out and back.
No, you can't. You literally are unable to draw it.
You take a -2 penalty.
I think Lux is looking at the rules right now.
You take a -2 penalty on attacks with it, but you can still use it.
Well.
Hey, Kiri.
So, Kiri, you have a cursed bow that you feel compelled to not get rid of.
Fuck.
Now, you don't necessarily have to use it, but you feel compelled to carry it around with you at all times, and should you ever choose to use it, you have to hit something with it in order for it to let you put it away.
Sounds like Kiri got a bow. But the problem is, he constantly will take a -2 because of the bow.
Only if he tries to use the bow.
He does not use it.
Yeah, he could always just carry the bow around forever and then just not get rid of it, but now he has a completely useless to him bow unless he somehow buffs his strength.
Or he could also just use it as his damage bow when he knows he's going to be able to hit something.
This is true. He could just use it as a blunt force bow.
Yeah, you do get, on top of your skirmish, you will get the plus...
You could also just try to break the curse on it with magic at some point down the road.
And then you just have a nice bow.
Sorry about that, Kiri, but one of us is going to be cursed, and it's better that it goes on to you.
Yeah, I don't think I want the.
You get this nice high damage bow. It doesn't hit. It doesn't hit very often, but it hurts like a fucking truck when it does.
Oh, I'm gonna see if I can find a mage when I get back home. Or someone holy.
We have a Church of Light.
I want to see the reaction to the Church of Light now when you show up. It's like, I got this bow.
Well, no, I want to see the reaction when I walk in with the portal orb, which is currently in my possession, wrapped in a sack.
I never said it was an orb, by the way. I said it was a gem.
Hold on. Tim's a cleric. Tim, can you decurse this spell?
Tim's not a cleric. Your headcanon is not true.
Damn it.
It cursed me more.
I'm going to crappily try and freehand what the gem looks like.
It looks like...
I'm just writing down portal gem drac.
So it looks like the rupee from Legend of Zelda.
Kinda.
Alright.
Basically.
So happy we've got Tim on our side now.
It's basically just a red rupee, like, that's about, you know, 12 inches long.
Yeah, I just wrote down portal gem drapped in cloth. Right? That's what I'm gonna do with it, alright? Alright, do we want to try and roleplay any with the elves and get back to town since Red's done what
I think it's like 12 o'clock and that maybe we just want to call it here?
That yeah.
Would be nice.
I know, I just...
I know, but fuck you.
Yeah, I know. I was expecting us to actually do some of that, but it was all combat because of those mobs.
Well, to be fair, I was playing this to be mostly combat anyway because basically you have to prove yourself before they'll talk to you because of your threat.
Well, they can go fuck themselves.
That's not fair on your part, no, but that's how these elves are.
I mean, they're friends.
Joy!
Yeah, Flux and Zod know the reason and could tell you at any time, but they just haven't.
Fuck you. You're kind of a dick. We took a while and we realized, hey, you're probably a dick.
And then you find out, hey, these guys are, like, protecting the world from, like, demon incursions over here this whole time. That's probably why they're a bit of an uppity bunch.
You know, it'd be nice if they would say that instead of, because in fucking Ymir's head, these guys are the reason why those infernal bugs existed.
And in their head, you're the reason they exist.
Yeah, that's why we butted heads so much.
What we have here is a failure to communicate.
Yes, that's exactly what we have.
But somehow I think in their head, I'm the one that did it.
I tried to communicate. Those assholes never tried.
They felt you weren't worth the effort. So communications breakdowns happened.
So
there was
a
breakdown of diplomacy.
Before we leave, I want to ask, did any of the elves see me jump into the portal?
I mean, none of them saw you jump into the portal, but they all watched you charge into the building.
Yeah. No, I mean, I wanted one of
them. When the portal shut, everything went back to normal outside, and you could see that since the roof isn't there. So everyone would notice that you ran into the building, and then some amount of time later, just the sky went back to normal.
Well, there's two things. I didn't want to destroy the gem because they could rebuild it on that side. I wanted to grab it, pull it over here, and then destroy it over here. That was my thought. That's why I grabbed
it. We could take it to someone.
No, we're taking it.
Not gonna lie, you did the one thing I thought you wouldn't be able to do or would even attempt to do, and you shut down the portal that the elves have been trying to close for fucking thousands of years.
Yeah. No, as soon as you
After making it worse for a bit, which if they'd found out about, probably would have pissed them off, but you managed to close it before they found out you made it worse for a while.
Don't understand why it made it worse. It's literally just throwing a sword and then having the sword come back.
It was like the fact that magic passed through the portal. Reacted to the magic.
Except it's like giving the weapon the property of returning.
Which is still magic. You offensively threw magic at the portal with the intention of destroying the portal. The portal reacted to the magical intention to destroy it.
Alright.
The portal's reaction was, lol, fuck you, I get bigger. Because that's what it was designed to do. Any attempt to destroy the portal makes the portal bigger.
Alright, just for the record, I am not putting the portal gem in my bag of holding.
I'm back.
Okay.
Okay. Probably a smart idea.
I don't know what that's going to do, but I know it's probably not going to be bad, so I just wanted to say that for record.
Thing capable of creating portals shouldn't go in the extra-dimensional portal space.
Yeah, I thought that would be a good idea.
The DM, if he was bored one day, might decide that causes issues.